his Twitch stream up.
No, nobody wants to see that. Oh god, no.
Look at who's talking. You're actually going to be on the stream. Ugh.
Oh yeah, that's true. I'm never on your stream.
Well, it's yours. You kind of wave.
What? Look at that, Halo. Look at that, Henzoid.
Girl, look at that body.
Yes.
Girl, look at that body.
Yes.
Worked out.
There is a 100% chance that PK will make something interesting this stream.
I really hope he makes a get thing. I want a get picture.
I really hope he doesn't. All right. Why do I have your character sheets again?
Isn't that like just something the DM's supposed to have, just in case?
Oh, yeah. Actually, that is a good idea. Thank you.
I think I gave you... Is my mic muted? No.
No.
Not currently, no. I can hear you.
I mean, we can hear you, so...
Hello, people. Can people hear everyone on stream?
Can you hear me now?
I can hear it coming in the air tonight. Anyway.
Are you just gonna sing Phil Collins all night?
Oh, Lord. Yeah. Oh, man.
What else do you do?
I on occasion upload Binding of Isaac videos.
So you're a one-trick pony, is what you're saying?
No, I'm a one-trick goat.
Oh. So even less useful.
Let's see. Ken still looks disturbing as
you?
Always.
Panda squid?
Panda. 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 Alright, so what are we doing tonight?
You tell me.
Oh.
Some shit.
For people that are just currently tuning in, which isn't an incredible amount yet, but we'll get those numbers up. What up, Crazy Dave? So, our party, we initially had a D&D group going, and unfortunately, due to various different things, that group kind of fell apart. You're currently looking at them, and we went from level one initially, made some fun characters, had some fun. That was all the shit that was currently on YouTube, and now we are deciding that we want to do the stream instead. I don't know, be a bit more fun that way.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Mix it up.
Maybe.
It'd be terrible.
Now for something entirely different.
Yeah. So this is what we're going to be doing. We are going to be streaming our adventures. Do we have an adventure name, a party name, or no?
Gep's Guild.
No. Gep's Guild.
Do
we have Gep's Guild? Yes, we do. Yes, we do. What is our Skype group called?
This is DNC or oh yes. So guys, this is going to be the epic adventure of the Squidly Diddlers.
Oh, that's right.
Diddlers. Yes.
I forgot about that.
Anyway, here's
the perfect name.
Oh my god, I forgot about that. Yeah, we have the Squidly Diddler sitting there. Okay, cool.
Hey, Hen, what's your character name?
Yeah, let's introduce everyone for people who have no idea what the fuck's going on.
Okay, so I am Mr. Damon, of course, and I'm playing as Cadian, the Orcish Death Knight that is completely combat strong but can't do jack else. Yeah.
And FYI day on stream, like, I actually put your name underneath your picture. Yeah, so well, that overlay then. I showed you, remember, it has everyone's
right
name underneath it.
Right,
but anyways, all right, let's do some actions. We had day.
I'm Geb, and I am playing Geb Gevinson. I am a Panda Bearkin Druid. I made my own circle, so I'm the Circle of Fladace. And yeah, that's my character.
All right.
Halo.
Okay. Well, I'm Halo. I'm playing Gumi, the Slime Girl, who's a Ranger Gunslinger.
I forgot about that.
Yep. But yeah. Now it's up for that other fuckboy.
You horrifying anthropomorphic cow.
I'm Henzoid. God damn it, I can't fucking breathe in this thing. I'm Henzoid, or my character is Iremir Malarum. I'm a Minotaur barbarian, and I'm allergic to gold.
But you have gloves that protect you from the gold.
Are we still going with that? Or
yeah.
Oh, okay. You dipped out for a second there.
Okay. Yeah, he has that.
Okay.
Let me reconnect.
Whoa, where'd you go?
We lost one.
You also kind of messed up the overlay doing that. Whatever. Yeah, you can. Oops. There's always one in the group, yeah.
Shit.
Okay, awesome. All right, so guys, for you guys who may not have known, because we all did this off camera, so I guess you wouldn't really know. The initial group that we were doing was the Lost Mines of Phandelver, which is the starter, like, adventure quest type thing that you get with the 5e D&D kit. So that was pretty much the, hey, you made a party. Hey, you go on a quest. Hey, you find a town. Hey, you find a bad guy, et cetera, et cetera. And it fell along with those lines. I thought, let's get rid of that because it's been overdone quite a bit. Yeah, I'm the DM. And, I've leveled all of them up to level 5, and then we have just started in the... shit, I have notes. Oh god, where'd my notes go? We started in the town of Bregrove. It is a keep of 1,000 people with a king no one has seen in years. So, this is some homebrew, some actual D&D lore. It's in the Forgotten Realms universe, so... Anyways, that is where we are. We're currently sitting in this town. Our party is sitting in a tavern currently, the scruffy dwarf, and they are just recounting the tales of an epic adventure that no one's ever going to hear about, but I'm sure they actually went on. Should you listen to this Adventure Zone podcast along with this too? Well, we're not affiliated, but it's still a good podcast.
The best podcast.
Yeah.
Besides ours. Ours is better.
Fuck yeah. Squidly yeah. Diddlers for the win. Oh, I should probably
totally not biased that. Opinions.
Yep, Dave, that's your character's face right there.
All right, there we go. Join the Squidly Diddlers. Oh god. Belgareth? What? What are you talking about? You have reference to Belgareth since he could be a part of everything. We have no Belgareth. At least I don't think I made a character named that.
Shit.
That's how I feel. Okay, so anyways, we are sitting in our nice little town of Bregrove with our party here. So I guess, I mean, we have people in. We might as well start.
All right. Okay.
If you want. So you see, you're sitting in the tavern. It is a pretty bustly little tavern. We have people of all different races, shapes, and sizes. There is, it's a big two-story tavern, and there is a very large, be about 6'4", guy behind the bar, tending it. You hear a bunch of noise. You hear people scattering about. There's smells, scents, tastes, and everything that you could possibly imagine here. This is like a smaller Neverwinter, pretty much.
Okay.
So there you guys are.
So, I'm just gonna go outside.
All right, go for it.
Halo, am I
in my jar?
Okay, are you still on my back and all that?
Yeah.
Okay,
I forgot about that.
So yeah, Gumi,
I'm gonna be end up following Geb as well because my character he's like the opposite of my character. He's intellectual but not physically strong, whereas I'm physically strong but not intellectual.
All right. Well, yeah, okay. So it's an orc, a slime, and a bear.
Walk into a bar. Yeah. Oh no, we're walking out of the bar. Never mind.
An orc, a slime, okay. A bear, yeah.
and a minotaur walk into a bar. Okay, let's go outside and see what's happening.
All right.
I've got a good buzz going. Let's get out of here.
Oh great, a giant bear having a buzz. That's going to be great. Okay, so
yeah, I just shared that video. Come on.
So as you guys are walking out, you hear the clitter clatter of hooves running towards you, and you can kind of hear people like, there's a sheep over there. Oh, and you can kind of hear a little bit of clitter clattering, like, meh, 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 meh. And this sheep walks up to you, just walks straight up to you and looks at you guys expectantly, and has a big scroll in his mouth.
I can, since I can talk to animals, I'm just going to say hi.
Brr.
Hold on. Brr, hi. Brr.
damn it.
You don't have to actually bleat.
I've been doing this the whole time. I don't know if I can handle this.
You don't have to actually bleat.
I imagine like, what's that game? Divinity or whatever? With the freaking French chicken and stuff?
Kind of like, meep, I have seen the end of the universe. Okay, so,
Is it an Elder Scroll?
That would be cool, huh? So you're talking to the sheep. The sheep kind of drops its mouth and, help me. It's all that you hear it say.
Some reason that's terrifying.
This is not an...
Since I can also talk to animals.
You have to cast the spell to talk to animals.
Oh, fine.
No, I'm just saying.
It's a level one spell. You gotta talk to animals.
Oh, if you gotta cast it, you gotta cast it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's not worth casting.
Okay. So, Mr. Horrifying Sheep Demon, what would you like? What's going on? How's it going?
Help me. I was changed against my will. You must save me. I used to be a powerful wizard.
Do you know a spell to help somebody?
No, I was betrayed.
You're a bad wizard, man. Wizard.
If you powerful wizard, why not? Oh wait, I can't hear him talk.
Yeah, you guys can't really hear him, unfortunately. Please,
I look over.
Open the scroll.
Hey, Cadian, this sheep's a wizard, and he doesn't know how to cast any spells. I'm not sure what to do.
Sounds like a bad wizard.
just read this scroll, please.
How does a wizard get turned into a sheep, but doesn't know how to turn himself back from being a sheep?
Okay, so I'll grab the scroll then. What's on the scroll?
Okay, as you open it up, it just kind of like a weird kind of feeling settles out through the whole party, through the squiddly diddlers, and all of a sudden all of you can understand the sheep, and I guess any other animals that are currently sitting around them. Oh, thank you, now you all can hear me. Oh, I need an adventurer party. You guys look good. Please, you must save me. I was turned this way by my apprentice.
That sheep is talking.
What's new?
thanks, Cadian. Thanks for the jab joke there.
Good job, Cadian. Good job.
Let me give you a pat on the back. There you go. Good boy.
Oh.
Cadian, you want a treat?
All right.
Like, seriously, this is my role in the group.
Dad jokes, all right.
Gumi pulls out a treat from the Cadian treat bag and gives it to Cadian.
It's a Cadian treat.
It's like a Scooby Snacks.
Oh my god.
So, who do we want? So, what should we do? What do you guys think?
Please, you must save me.
Well, I'm not talking to you, sheep. I'm talking to my friends.
You're a bastard.
I don't know if I want to help the sheep now.
All right, I'm going to...
Very rude.
Please. He will do much worse to you, people.
Wait, what do I have a... I was going to set him on fire, but never mind.
All right, well, as you guys are...
Never smells good.
As you guys are sitting there kind of, like, you know, talking to him and whatnot, you hear a bunch of bustling behind from a large crowd, and you can hear these bigger footsteps. Thump, 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 thump. As you look over, and they kind of just, like, burst through the small crowd of people that is now staring at a bunch of adventurers yelling at a sheep, you see that there is a giant half-orc, and he is commanding a trio of big wolves that are on big collars.
Okay.
All right.
Can you still hear us, then?
The call just kind of screwed up a little bit.
Cadian, like you're an orc. Talk to them.
What's up, brother?
I don't remember seeing you in town. What's your name? Listen, it doesn't matter. There's no time for that. I need that sheep.
Listen, brother.
Listen here, brother.
What's up, brother?
Oh my god.
I'm going to cast Charm Person.
Wait, what are you doing? What are you doing here?
I'm not doing anything. He can't hear me. He can't hear me say it.
How do you cast a Charm Person?
So, I attempt to charm it. It must make a wisdom saving throw and does so with advantage if we're fighting it. Ew. But we're not fighting it. By hand. Until spell ends. So, for an hour.
Okay. So, for a full hour, he is pretty much... Is he... No, it's not Hulk Hogan.
So, you have to roll.
Okay. What am I rolling for?
You have to get over a 14.
Over a 14?
Yeah.
Okay. So he,
for you have for to a, let me know if it works, by the way.
It didn't, no.
Damn it.
Yeah.
You know, he knows he was charmed, then.
Oh, he knows
or
it?
Tried
okay.
To be charmed. Yeah.
All right. You can see that he's visibly getting, like, more puffy, and he's,
Wait, before you do it.
What?
I go, you activated my trap card.
Go away.
Thank you, Amnesiac.
That's how I feel right now. Oh my god.
Okay, so
yeah, he sits there and he kind of like shakes it off and he's looking like,
what were you trying to do to me? Listen, I need that sheep. I need that damn sheep and I need it now.
And he's kind of like shaking the chains of the wolves and he's kind of edging towards you. We're trying to get,
Payment
or Kenzoid working, but it's not.
He might not be able to do it. If
no, Oh, that's breaking the illusion.
Hen, are we doing it? Yes, no, man? What's going on?
I think so. I think it's working.
Hen,
I can hear you.
We can hear you. So if your Wi-Fi is screwing up so much that your camera can't work, just turn off the camera and you can just listen. And
yeah,
just
I mean, that'd,
talk.
That'd be fine.
Yeah. They've got us three semi-beautiful faces.
It'll just be a constant loading screen on the chat there.
There we go.
Then we have to make some radical readjustments really quickly. So,
Right.
Let's just do that. Let's get back. Oh, man, that messed up everything on there.
Cancer, noun, definition. Oh, God. One, this cat, the illusion. Two Kenzoid.
Looks okay. Like a... I'm trying to break free of my own picture, trying to break into Hen's.
Yeah, it does kind of look like that, huh? Okay, let's try to... That's funny.
Kenny goes immediately to banging the sheep. Great.
No, I'm not that kind of slime.
I mean, technically Hen is, but I mean...
Oh my god. Yeah, Halo... This is fucking up badly.
Oh, there we go.
Are we ready to keep going? Are you?
Oh god, everything's all screwed up.
I guess I'll just put fucking Hen's picture there as well instead. You're still here, right, Hen?
Mm-hmm.
Are you still here?
Yeah.
You still have those extra spicy memes, my friend?
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure. I'm going to use your fucking weird hot and spicy picture instead.
Oh, are you actually?
Yes, I am actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is gonna be great.
Oh boy.
There we go. Okay, now we have a picture of Hen eating me in close enough. A sausage outfit. Alright, that's just great. Okay. I guess are we good back again?
Are we good?
Yeah, we're good.
It seems like Geb is messing up again.
Geb and Dave's things are a little bit off, but it's fine.
Are they?
It's not working right. Am I moving?
No. It's the boxes aren't lined up.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever.
I think. All right, there we go. We're good. Dave, I'm just leaving you. Screw it.
Fine.
Yes, you were a baka, Mr. Damon. Okay. So the half orc kind of, he's still sitting there. He's shaking his chains with the wolf on you. He's like, "Listen, I need that sheep. Give it to me right now." And he's starting to kind of like puff up. You can see he's edging towards his weapon.
Wait, do you really need the sheep?
Look, I need the sheep. And I'm not
Are you
taking...
sure that's the right sheep?
I'm not taking no for an answer.
I saw a sheep go that way. You sure it wasn't that sheep?
Listen, this is Maston Oak sheep.
I'm going to cast Minor Summoning.
What are you going to summon?
I'm going to summon a... It's going to look like a... I can't attack him, but he doesn't know that. It's a Black Widow. And I'm going to have a big Black Widow appear above his head and slowly go right down onto his head.
Are we talking, like, Black Widow the size of you, or just, like, a large spider?
A Black Widow, like, the size of his head. Mm. Slowly crawling onto his head.
Why is the widow gotta be black?
Damn it.
Is it, like, a thing I roll for or save?
No. It just summons. I just summon it, and it goes right down. It can't attack, but he doesn't know that. It's just a giant Black Widow just starts going right onto his head.
Okay. Well, Jesus. The one the size of his head. Holy Christ.
But it's...
I know for a fact I would take off faster than that spider could fall on my face.
He... All right. Let's see. He... As the Black Widow is kind of just moving slowly right onto his head, he's completely oblivious. He's focusing only on this sheep. So as it's kind of... focusing on that, he goes,
fucking
he starts batting at it and freaking out. Get that away from me.
That is terrifying.
It smacks it off into the crowd. It lands on a small child, and the child's screaming.
God.
He's like, listen. Wait. All right, that's it. I tried to be nice.
Yep, I got an idea.
What?
I then jump out of my jar onto the roof.
Roll for initiative.
Climb up.
Oh god, no, not again. Not again.
Are you really trying that one again?
Yeah, it'll work this time, I swear.
Alright, go for it.
I rolled a 18.
Alright, go for it.
Alright, throw it to me. Throw me the sheet. I catch it.
Make a strength check, Geb.
Oh, fuck.
Oh wait, no. I'll do the strength check.
Oh god.
Yeah, okay, please do the strength check, please.
I'm dead. Throw me the sheep. I'll catch it.
Okay. Strength check. That is what? 1d20?
Yes.
Plus your modifier.
Yeah. I rolled a 19.
There we go. Yeah. All right.
Weird. That is exactly what I rolled. All right. So as you throw up the sheep, you see that the half-orc, he pretty nimbly dashes and pretty much bats the sheep down. He lands just barely off of the same little child that just got covered by the Black Widow.
So Dave's modifier doesn't like give him the edge.
No, if it's
No. Okay, I rolled a 16 with a +3 modifier, so I rolled a total of 19.
Yeah. So right. And that's so that happens.
Or did.
Well,
okay. So yeah, all the while, the sheep is just screaming. I mean, you guys can hear him, but the rest of the crowd's just saying,
Is there anything behind us?
You are currently standing in the opening of the tavern.
No, I mean, like, so we're saying, so he's blocking the way. I am going to grab the sheep, go out the back.
Okay, if you'd like to. A sheep's pretty damn heavy. You're going to have to make a strength check.
I'm a bear.
That is true, but you're still it's still a sheep. It's a good, like, 80, 90-pound sheep. What'd you get?
I'm not 20.
Jesus. All right. You grab the sheep, and you run
I carried that goddamn sheep.
All right, so before the half-orc could run and grab the sheep, you nimbly dash over to it. Nice. You nimbly dash over to it, grab it, and then you haul ass right through the tavern.
Okay, I'm gonna try to jump back onto Geb's back as he makes it out the other side of the tavern.
All right, and as he launches off, you just narrowly slip back into your, I guess, what is it? You have a big jar sitting on there.
Jar attached to him.
And let's see. At this point, I'm gonna be summoning my two axes and standing guard at the door so they can get back out through the tavern.
Thank you, KDM. Let's go.
I'm just running with them.
Okay, did you guys get pretty
much... the big Minotaur's pretty much just been standing there the whole time, not doing anything.
Is there a back door?
So you pretty much just burst back through this tavern, this full tavern.
carrying a sheep.
Is there like a back door or anything, or am I just like blasting through the wall?
In your
oh no
roll a perception check at disadvantage.
That is another.
I got this imagining shopkeeper. You gotta pay for that.
Oh wait, no, that's a. Is it plus my modifier, right?
Yeah, but disadvantage is you roll two, and the worst of the two you take.
Yeah, the lowest one was 8 plus 6.
She's up for perception?
Yeah, I'm wisdom. Druid is wisdom, remember?
Right, that's right, I forgot. Okay. Okay, well, you happen, as you're bursting through, knocking over tables and throwing people out of the way, just beer steins and everything flying as you guys are just launching through this tavern. You just barely manage to hear the barkeep yell out, "Oh, just to the right!" And as you look, you see that there is just this nice big gaping door open, and you burst right through it out into the back alley.
You just plunge right through that back door.
Where are you guys going from here?
I'm still standing up front, standing guard.
Can I roll a perception check to see which way to go?
You can. Like, I just want to let you know that at this point, the orc has let go of the wolves, and they're hauling ass after you.
Oh, no.
Three wolves.
I'll fight those bitches.
I'm entering combat at this point, then, aren't I?
You are rolling for initiative day.
Okay, then. D20.
Damn.
I am going to... Can I summon conjure animals?
If you'd like, yeah.
Okay, it's a third level conjuration. I summon face spirits that take the form of beasts.
Okay.
Beasts. Yes, bees. That is what he said, bees.
The bees!
Not the bees!
Not the bees!
Okay, so I summon...
Roll a Nicolas Cage check.
I'm not sure how many...
Page 220 to what?
225. I have to see what it...
What?
Conjure animals, so I can do... I'm going to... Oh my god. I'm going to conjure 8 beasts of challenge rating of 4th.
What?
It's a 3rd level spell.
Jesus Christ. What are you summoning?
How about 8, like, wolves?
Oh god!
That are challenge rating of 4th.
Challenge rating of 4?
No, a 4th.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say yeah, because that is what a wolf is. Okay. Okay, so you.
Holy crap! That would be so OP.
So you're fighting fire with fire or wolf with wolf?
Yeah. So I'm.
How many wolves are currently after Hold on.
How does this make sense, though? They're at the back end of the tavern, and I'm still standing guard at front, having the wolves come after me.
They're friendly. They're friendly to all of us.
Okay,
that's right. Yeah, you were blocking it. Okay.
I'm blocking the front door right now and letting them get out the back.
And what did you roll for your initiative?
I rolled a 16 plus 2 for my initiative modifier.
Jesus. Okay. You're going first then.
Okay.
They're kind of sitting there growling at you. They're trying to like sneak around you as you're standing there.
Okay. How far away are they?
They're within attacking distance. Remember, this is okay, a big, like, bustling street, so.
Yeah, and I was going to say, I'm dual wielding great axes, so.
Oh, great. Okay, go for it. There's currently one sitting in front of you, and like I said, the other two are trying to flank you.
Okay, well, as a level 5 DK, I get 2 attacks, so I'm going to attack the one in front of me and then the one next to me.
Oh god! Okay, roll the attack dice. So
that would be a d20.
Yeah, I guess roll it twice. You're trying to beat a 13.
I get plus 6 for my attack bonus, so I got a 10 and a 13, so it's a 16 and a 19.
Okay, you definitely hit them then. all right, roll.
That's not OP or anything.
All right, what is your weapon roll? Like, how much damage are you doing?
1d12 plus 3.
Alright, so roll 2 of those then.
2d12 plus 6 is going to be...
Well, no, roll 1d12 plus 3 each.
Okay.
Yeah, because you're rolling for each weapon.
Okay.
Yeah. Because 2d12 plus 6 would be a lot of damage. Well, comparative.
Okay, so 1d12 plus, not 30, 3.
Plus come 30, on. Holy come Christ.
Okay, I roll a 6 and a 7 for damage.
Okay, that's fine.
Oh, man.
So a total of 13 on that first wolf.
Okay, a total of 13. Okay, so as the wolf tries to start, you know, it's testing its ground, trying to make sure, you just take this big great axe with a big swing, thud, and just catch it right in the head, and just thoop, it just goes straight down. This wolf is
wolves,
done.
Man.
It just goes thoop.
And how much is the damage on the second one?
Let me see here. Roll. Total of 12.
12? Okay. So, as the first wolf kind of cracks with a sickening crack and just hits to the ground, the second wolf is kind of taken aback and just long enough for you to swing your axe and just cleave it right in the side. And the other wolf just bounces to the ground. There's still the third wolf sitting there, and the half-orc is just staring incredulously at you. Like, you killed my puppies!
What? In previous D&Ds, we've also mutilated wolves horribly.
Yeah, that's so, you guys really like mutilating dogs.
Why is that a theme?
All right, so yeah,
wolf
this
mutilation.
So yeah, as the orc is watching this whole thing going on, and he's just like, you just cleaved my puppies in two. And he is not and happy.
I just pick up my axes, dripping with his puppy's blood, look at him and smile.
Oh, God, you are horrifying.
Well, considering he's an undead orc on top of him being...
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm an orc with bloodlust that's undead and an agent of death. What do you think I'm going to be reacting right now?
That's right. Overpowered. Okay, so the second wolf tries to jump at you, but it just narrowly misses right past you, and it kind of lands where the other wolf is just where the wolf corpse is sitting there, and okay,
and is traumatized for the very short rest of its life.
Oh God, this is all right. This is interesting. What's your AC? Is your AC?
My AC is 14.
14. Okay.
Yep.
So the half-orc sits there, and he is not happy right now. So he comes to run up, and he tries swinging right at you, and with a nice big greatsword, and he swings and just kind of catches you on the side. It's kind of like a glancing blow on your arm, and you only take 5 damage.
Okay. I need to get a notepad because my pen suddenly disappeared.
And it is your turn again.
It is. Wait, my where turn am again. I?
Huh?
Where's Hannah?
I said
yeah. Need
to go fight the wolves also.
Weren't you chasing after Geb?
Yeah, isn't Day with Geb?
No, Day is sitting. Yeah.
He's in the Geb, front, and we're in the back.
Yeah. Geb and I are just kind of listening to like these like horrible sounds of wolves getting chopped in half and shit.
Well, I'm trying to do a perception check to see where to go and haul ass.
All right, what's that perception?
Like, choice fine.
I got 14, so I got 20, not nat, but a 20.
Okay, so 20. Okay, so you see that to the left, it just goes a small alleyway down where there's a few people just kind of sitting there, and then there's just a straight brick wall. There is just no outlet there at all. And to the right, it's back out into the bustling street, but to the, like, on the around of the tavern.
I think I will head to the right, and before we run, I'm just going to yell at Cadian, go to the right, and then I'm just going to book it.
Okay, so as you book it, a large bear happened to show up right in that pathway that you were sitting at.
You
boy, I'm a bear. Get out of the way, Geb.
No,
no, I'm a bear.
He had another companion that was outside of...
Oh shit, you are a bear.
Yeah, there was another bear in the back. There was someone who polymorphed into a bear. You didn't see it.
I go up to him and I go.
Bears and then...
Sorry?
What?
Hold on, Geb.
Yeah?
What were you?
Well, I was going to say, does he speak Bearkin?
He could possibly, if you want to try a persuasion check.
Okay.
I guess.
Where the hell?
Yes, that's totally what we meant by bear, Carl.
Persuasion. Oh, that is a 12.
Yes, yes. There is a large, hairy, gay man standing in the way.
Gary Busey.
That was a 12. Yes, Gary Busey is standing there.
Okay.
No, Gary Busey.
Gary Busey in a bear costume is standing there, ready to fight us.
Okay, I guess you're talking to the bear. It took him off guard, and he's just kind of sitting there as you're growling at him. What are you saying?
I'm just saying, hey, how's it going? Mind moving out of our way before I split you in two?
Oh, that's aggressive.
He takes it the wrong way, doesn't he?
The bear sits there and he's like, I may no do that.
He's not my kind guy.
Me need chase sheep. And all the while, this the townspeople are just hearing.
you want chase sheep? I cast minor summoning of a sheep. And I summon a sheep, and it goes off.
Now, since he saw that, does he have some type of role he has to do?
No, it summons a sheep. It's just a sheep.
Okay, just straight up, like poof, a sheep appears.
Yeah, it's just a sheep.
In a small little haze, the sheep appears and, he just kind of trots on off, and the bear's like, thank you, and he just runs off onto the sheep.
It's a non-violence. We win the day, and I just go off.
How many spells can you cast, Geb?
That's a cantrip.
It's a cantrip.
No. We never did the conjure animals I said I was going to do, and that never happened. So the minor summons. Okay. It only summons a CR0, so they can't attack or anything. It's just a little.
You're pretty much just like summon an animal and that's it. And
yeah, it doesn't. Yeah, it can't attack or anything. I can tell it what to do, but it doesn't attack or anything.
Okay, gotcha. Okay, so as this hole is going on. There is currently a Mr. Damon fighting an orc and a wolf.
Yes.
In the front.
I like how we're just kind of all just scattered around and while Dave is killing everything.
Did he hear me yell where to go?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I did. I go, my right, you're right.
as this whole thing is going on, the sheep in your arms is like, wow, you guys are having a bad time.
Shut up, sheep! And I just
we don't need to hear it.
Oh my god!
Okay. So do I need to then?
Yeah.
Is it
all right? You
back
to
combat?
Yeah, I guess you do.
Okay.
You do your thing.
Okay, I'm taking a swing at the wolf first.
Okay. Yeah, the wolf was kind of toppled over through its attack, so you have advantage on it. Roll that attack dice.
So roll 2d20 and take the better of the two, then?
Yes. And you're trying to pass a 13.
Okay. I got a 15.
Okay. So you swing, and then make that attack swing. Like, what
make
the
that
damage?
Attack swing. 1d12 plus 3 times 2. Total of 13 damage.
13 damage? All right. So with this, with one of your axes, as the wolf is just getting up, it kind of like looks up, it gives you the puppy dog eyes, and then with a big sickening crack again, and the dog's head is no longer attached to its body. And there,
oh my.
And through this whole time, these onlookers have just been staring in horror as you're dismembering wolves. And
yeah, I mean, holy fuck.
Oh, make sure God. To skin them. We can sell their belts.
All right. Oh, jeez. All right.
Let's see.
Is that kid there?
The kid just finally wrestled the Black Widow off of it, and it's just looking as you're destroying dogs in front of you.
Okay. Let's see.
Trauma by mutilation.
And he okay. At this point, the orc is kind of sitting there. He's like, all right, hold on a second.
I was going to say, I still have a second attack that I could come after him with on my turn.
Yeah, he tried a persuasion check, but it was a critical fail.
Nice.
Listen, we can talk about this, alright? Alright.
Nope.
Alright. Go for that attack roll again.
17 plus 6, 23.
For the attack roll or for the damage roll?
The attack roll.
Oh, okay. Jesus. Okay, and what's the damage you're doing?
Is a total of 14.
14 damage? Jesus. Okay. As he's sitting there like, all right, listen, we can take that. You just catch him right in the fucking chest with this axe. And he just goes, whoop, and launches right into the crowd. And it crushes... There's this very large half-orc just crushed a family of two, and he kind of falls on the ground and sits
there.
Oh
my goodness.
You piece of shit.
And I guess he is prone, so he currently cannot do anything this turn.
End of campaign.
And there you go.
We win!
You have beaten the unnamed half-orc. No, he's kind of sitting there. And he's kind of just struggling to get up. Wow. You guys really fucked him up.
What are you talking about? That was all...
He did. We're out of there.
I know. Okay, so, yeah, he's just trying to get up at this point. Like I said, he is prone, so he can't do anything this turn.
Okay.
Listen, I don't even care anymore. I just want the sheep.
He's still kind of, like, yelling and talking.
Christ.
Oh my god. Look who's in the chat.
Yeah.
Just finish him off.
Just finish him off.
Alright, roll that attack at advantage since he's pro.
Maybe we should see why he wants the sheep.
Listen.
He's already said multiple times.
I've just done a fetch quest from my master.
Okay. Ooh, master.
Oh, God, that fucking hurt in my shoulder.
He kind of is like shambling to get up, and he says, "Oh,
down out of the town, Master Noke. He's a wizard. That's his sheep. I was just his bodyguard. I just need the goddamn sheep."
Your master's wizard sheep is a wizard?
Oh, I don't even know. At this point, oh god. Oh my.
I'm blasting ears out periodically, sorry.
Yeah, I got that too a couple times.
Yeah.
It's like the orc like fading. I mean, like...
You didn't exactly like deal him a mortal wound, but he definitely is not happy, but he can't really... He's not moving too quickly right now. But he's sitting there like, listen, I'll goddamn pay you, I don't even care. I just need the goddamn sheep.
And at this point, like, the town's guard are all coming up. They're kind of looking like, you know, trying to break on through.
What the shit happened?
Yeah, see what's going on with all this.
Trying to see why there's a dead family of two and a bunch of dead wolf carcasses.
Yeah, you guys are...
giant spider. Don't forget the giant spider.
But it can't hurt anybody.
Giant spider, traumatized kid, mutilated wolves, and dead family. We have left quite a legacy for ourselves.
We are never
allowed back in this town ever again.
Ever. Oh my god.
Oh man.
Okay.
Okay, but yeah, okay, so he's just sitting there like, oh god, I don't even care. And he's one of the town's guard come to look at him. He's like, oh, no, I'm fine. I'm with Master Noke. And you kind of notice that, like, he's like, oh, okay, you know, and he starts helping the half-orc up. He is still not... No, you can't fuck the orc. Okay, so... Anyway. Yeah, what were you people?
I've been whispered something. Hold on.
Yeah, I saw that too. I'm not gonna worry about it right now. Okay, so yeah, you're sitting there. He's just kind of like, "God damn it, where'd your goddamn bear go?"
No, Carl.
Okay, no, Carl. Where'd your
goddamn bear go?
And I guess it's back. Where is everyone right now? I'm confused.
Gab and I just took off. I have no idea where we are currently.
Okay, you're sitting on the other side of the tavern.
We're outside of the tavern.
I guess I'm just following them. I'm not really sure.
I kind of, like, left, and I was just kind of going a bit of a ways, and then I was just waiting for Cadian.
Okay. Okay,
got it. Am I pronouncing your name correctly?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Good. I'm making sure.
I thought it was Cadian for some reason.
Cadian.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm just kind of waiting for him.
All right, and you can okay. You can see he kind of, the orc kind of gets hobbled back up, and he kind of just walks off with the guard, and there is still okay. A very large crowd, incredulous at the scene that just unfolded in front of all of them.
Okay.
And the bartender yep. kind of walks up from outside, and he's like, oh, you boys, you cause trouble, don't you? He's kind of just sitting there shining his glass. You're going to pay for all this, right?
No.
Oh, that started out sounding like something completely different, but yeah.
I start, Caden starts looking in his pockets, trying to find some money, and pulls out empty pockets and shows him.
I don't have pockets, so that's...
Thought you were following us, and we're nowhere near the inn.
All right.
I don't know. I don't know anymore.
Pick where you want to be. Do you want to be with Day, or do you want to be with us?
I'm with you, and I'm with you. I don't know.
Make up your damn mind.
Okay. I'll make up his mind for him. I'm by myself out front. He's following you two.
All right.
Okay.
And yeah. Okay. I guess since you guys are sitting in the back of the tavern, and the sheep's just he can kind of like hear what's going on, so he's kind of noticing everything. So he's like, that orc was really a mutton for punishment.
You know.
God damn it.
Get out.
My character then reaches around with slime and covers the fucking sheep's mouth. He doesn't want to hear any more dumb puns.
That's probably not going to happen. He just gets, like, munching on the slime.
No. She retracts her slime and goes, ew.
Oh, god damn. Okay, so... So the sheep is sitting there like, I think the coast is clear for right now. I think we... Look, I have a problem. They're going to keep searching me. They're going to keep sending people after me. I need your help.
What you need, bro? Look, we got you.
I don't know if I want to help the sheep. I don't want to help him.
No, I'm helping him. We got you, bro.
But we're going to have to listen to his dumb puns the entire trip.
I love puns.
Oh man!
So wait. So you've been in this place for what? A few minutes. You've already injured/killed dozens of people, destroyed a tavern, and mentally scarred a kid. A great start to an adventure.
Damn straight, Carl.
Damn straight, Skippy.
Don't forget mutilated wolves. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep.
Yep. Can't forget that.
Oh,
we
God.
Are amazing.
Okay.
Yeah, there are infinite towns for us to just absolutely demolish.
Okay, so the sheep is sitting.
Hen will do a good job of that.
Listen.
Yep.
If you help me, I'll stop with the euphemisms.
Oh my god, do you want to be lamb chops? Fucker?
Never stop the puns. Keep the puns alive.
Oh
all right.
My god.
I kind of want to make mutton out of this.
For the love of Christ, just help me.
I asked you, what do you need, bro?
Okay, here's my story. So... I'm not going to do that voice that whole time. That's fucking killing me. I can't keep doing that.
Here you go. Do you want some?
Thanks. I appreciate. No, I got Yoo-hoo. I'm fine.
Give me a Yoo-hoo.
So the
Yoo-hoo.
So the sheep. The sheep's going. My
not
name
sponsored
is
sponsored by Yoo-hoo.
My name is Fine. My name is Finther Shinebright, and I was once the great wizard that, as I'm sure you may have heard, Master Noke is now taking up residence in. I used to be this town's wizard. I used to help the people with lots of different problems, and people far and wide from all the different neighboring countries and towns came to see me. And in my haste, I unfortunately was caught off guard and betrayed by my apprentice, who is now what he calls Master Noke. I had a very, very powerful tool, a wand of true polymorph, and it turned... He used it when I was sleeping, and he turned me into this sheep, and now I'm sitting here. I need help getting back my tower. I need help just not being a sheep anymore.
Alright, yeah.
Okay, but why sheep?
It was just the first thing that happened.
Why not?
I'm just, please keep me away from the farmers near the end of the town.
Why are those the goat fuckers?
Thank God I'm not a goat. I would definitely be a sheep date.
God damn it. All right, so I raise my hand and I go, I vote to help the guy out.
That is a good question. How can we believe that the sheep is a moral upstanding greater than our party of adventurers?
So
what the fuck?
What?
You don't see the chat?
Yeah, I have a skeleton. We're gonna have to time you out, Buttergutted. Okay. I'm fucking timing out everyone. Okay. So yeah, the sheep is pretty much sitting there, and he needs help. Do you help him? Do you turn him into mutton? Like, what's going on? Look, I can offer you great compensation. I was a very powerful wizard. I can bring many things at your disposal. Thanks. I can give you many magical items. I can give you help in your travels. I can give you money. Anything. Just help me.
Anything?
Anything.
Almost anything.
What's the almost?
How soft is that wool?
Oh my.
Okay. So who wants to help him? Who doesn't?
I don't have help a vote because I'm still away from you guys.
I don't know. The sheep seems fishy to me.
How about we go back to Cadian, we group up, figure out what we want to do, and then we can go.
Are we sure this sheep isn't trying to pull the wool over our eyes?
God damn it.
That's so good, though.
It is good.
I don't know. I don't know. I'm a little sheepish around him, though.
That one was forced.
It was. You've done this to me.
Cadian's okay. Just kind of standing in front of the tavern, spinning in circles, still going, my right, your right.
Okay, we come back. What's up, Cadian? So, and I explain exactly what's going on.
That not right, that left.
It's okay, buddy.
Okay, Cadian. Just here, Cadian.
If I may have a treat. What is Cadian's intelligence?
I have a -1 modifier. Yeah, it's 8.
Okay, just wondering. Just got it.
Gotcha. Gumi gives Katie a treat for at least trying to figure out which direction to go to.
I feel like 5 is like you're mentally challenged. 8 is like you're a little dumb, but you can still...
5, I think, is like the possible lowest you could roll if you were rolling a certain way. Like, I think you still start at least at 8. So,
with the point buying system, you always start at 8.
Yeah. But if there was another way where you roll like 4d12s or something like that, added up and
yeah.
Hen, quit banning breath.
Yeah.
Did you not ban? Oh, you time out. You don't ban.
Same thing.
No, it's not.
To be fair, if you hit the timeout button, it shows as a ban.
Although. Geb did time out Buttergod for like 30 minutes.
That's fine. I don't care.
No, it timed him out, and then for some reason it untimed him out, and then I timed him again.
Okay.
Okay.
Hey, cool. We get to actually moderate the chat while doing this. Cool.
Yay!
Well, I was going to make a joke, but I was like, no, like, literally all of my mods are in this with me, so...
Yep.
Except for Carl and people who don't exist, apparently.
Yeah, we don't need Carl, though.
Who's Halo? He's one of my mods, Halo of the Suns.
Okay.
Is that all we are to you now? Mods.
There he is. Okay, so what is it you guys doing?
I'm trying to take a vote for everybody. So I everybody who wants to help the this little sheep, raise your hand.
I mean...
we can't see the other two.
Just say yes. I didn't think that was true.
I would like to help.
Okay, so that's 3. All right, so let's do it.
Okay.
Fine. The sheep says, you want each sheep, but me help, I guess.
The sheep says, thank you. I've been on the lamb for a month.
God damn it.
can we put a muzzle on him? Can we do that?
Before we do that, okay... Do you have any idea of what we should do, or should we just go in there and murder everybody and get your thing back?
Yes. Oh.
Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Look, the half-orc that your... Oh, yeah. I can't do that. The half-orc that your friend almost cleaved into, he is the quote-unquote bodyguard of Master Noak. However, he's just a big brute that follows him around and he paid for. Look.
Carl, shut the fuck up.
I like that idea, though, of Carl. Beat the sheep, tenderize it for later.
Gideon, carry my jar.
We'll beat the sheep, that's for sure.
Your jar is still on my back.
We're reading this all on Google Glass.
Yeah, that's definitely what we're doing.
Okay, so I guess we should just go and murder everybody. Is everybody good with that?
Look.
Okay.
So
Kaden just smiles.
The sheep is sitting there like, he has a large army building. He has captured mercenaries and he's turned them into his army. It's not going to be easy, that's for sure. But I promise you, I can give you many, many great riches if you help me out. I can show you where my lair used to be, and now Master Noak resides in it.
Once again, how soft is your wool?
You can touch me once.
I don't mean like
he's consenting. Just take the opportunity.
If I was to make a blanket out of you.
Okay.
Okay, can we just keep going? Yeah, we're just going.
Okay,
keep going.
Yeah, this just got super awkward. Let's move on.
Yeah, we'll help you out. I'm trying to figure out how to like fight this army though.
Okay. It's not too hard. We can sneak in. It'll be great. Here, let me show you.
We're known for is sneaking.
Huh?
Yes,
that's what they're perfect at. The squiddly diddlers are the
Hey, I am a very, very stealthy slime.
Hey, apparently in the last one, Henzoid was a fucking stealth minotaur that could jump up rock faces with no one knowing.
Okay, let's go.
All right, so
it won't be that bad. It's just a bear minotaur. What are you, an orc thing?
I'm an orc.
Yeah, an orc, a slime, and a sheep.
We're good.
Yeah,
there's
completely with the motley crew.
Someone give the sheep a weapon.
Oh my god!
Like a battle axe.
I'm already bad to the bone.
Did anybody else catch what Henzoid just said, though?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, do we have a cart or anything?
You don't really need a cart. We're just going to go straight. Here, I'll lead the flock. And he walks off in front of you.
I'll go on all fours and just start going.
Okay. If you would like to.
On all fours, you go double speed, right?
I go to 60 feet.
Oh, damn, you can crawl pretty quick.
Then I shall do the same thing, and I go to 70 feet per thing.
Okay.
That sounds like a run at that point.
Yeah, that's more of a run. I'm not sure if minotaurs are good runners or if they're just chargers. I don't know.
Well, Mr. D, you want to... 35.
Do you want to ride on top of him?
Oh!
And then, because I have Gumi on my back.
Mm.
And then the sheep, is the sheep fast enough?
Why can't they mount you? I weigh 50 pounds at most.
But then I have three people who are on my back, and he has none.
Oh. Carry me.
Nope.
Okay, carry me.
No. They can ride him.
Nope. I don't need to. I wave my hand and summon.
Oh, that's
my
right.
Mount.
You have a mount. I forgot you have a mount.
I have a bound mount.
Okay,
so close.
So
close.
Squiddly diddlers, ahoy! And we just ride off.
this is ahoy? Why ahoy?
Because ahoy.
This is definitely a unique party. Okay, so you guys are walking on out, and you're leaving this this town of Bregrove, or this small city, I should say. It's a large keep. There are a big set of doors that are currently open, guards standing there. People coming in and out. You can tell this is a pretty big trade town, and the sheep is kind of trotting on off, just straight on down the road.
No one questions this.
Nope.
It's D&D. They know us. We're good. We're adventurers.
I was going to say, I do not have the mental capacity to question things.
After Day's horrifying testament to his strength and ability in the middle of the town, not too many people are questioning anything from you guys right now.
Plus, aren't you on, like, an undead horse of, like,
yeah,
doom and destruction? Yeah.
I'm on a skeletal horse that is wearing tatters of armor.
Are you sure that Day isn't just like famine or something? One of the four horsemen.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my
god. He's basically his WoW character.
Yep.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, so the sheep is kind of just trotting on off, and he's going straight down. It's more of a less traveled road. You see a few people that are wandering about, and that's about just some small traders sitting on the side of the road talking to people and whatnot.
Traders or traitors?
Traders. People trading things. Giving things, selling, etc., etc.
Yes, and pestilence as an undead.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm pestilence.
All right, let's go.
Okay, so he's trotting on off for about a mile or two. You just hear him kind of like singing and bleeding to himself, and there is kind of like a what's the word, a threshold kind of sitting in this big patch of grass and woods. It's kind of grown over. It looks almost like a big gated fence, but not exactly, and the gates are opened. It's pretty dark, and he says, it's down there. This is where we must go.
All right, so let's can I roll a perception check just to see, like, does the sheep know exactly where to stealth? Like what's the stealthiest, best area to go through, or do we need to perception check it?
The sheep does, yes.
Okay, then I'll kind of, like, whisper to him, like, where do we go?
Okay. All right, let's go. We still have about a mile up. That's when they are going to start getting sentries throughout the woods. So he just kind of trots on off. He's trotting on off into the dark. He says, watch out. There's lots of thorns and whatnot. There may be traps.
I can alter plan.
Can you?
Yeah, my alter plan cantrip.
Why are you too powerful? You're too powerful.
Yeah, really.
No, none of this is damage spells.
Literal power. No.
No, like my entire thing is like a little bit of utility and healing. I have, like, no damage.
Well, currently, I'm sure later on you'll get stuff.
Yeah, but right now, like,
I mean, you're level 5, so, I mean, you can't really...
Yeah, you know. But I'm, like, utility and a half.
Okay, so so you guys are heading on off. I'd say about... Who is leading? Who is following? Who is, like, where is... What's your party makeup right now?
Well, isn't the sheep
one of our group?
I know the sheep is walking forward, but who is following him closest and farthest away?
Well, so the tankiest should be in the front, and I think that's me.
Well, should I be in the front, kind of using alter plan to, like, make the thorns go away to look at stuff?
Yeah, I guess so.
So we can have me there, have whoever wants to be behind me kind of protecting me, watching my back.
Yeah.
And then I think we should have the other tank in the very back kind of keeping an eye out for us.
Okay, that'd be me.
And then we could have Halo as the third.
Okay.
Well, Halo's just kind of on your back.
Oh, that's right. You're on my back. Never mind. I have somebody watching out for me.
See,
okay. So the order is she.
Sorry?
I could get out of my me. Jar.
Okay.
And so. I could hide in your fur because I could lie myself completely flat.
So, sheep.
That's just like a moist towel.
Sheep, Geb, Halo, Hens, me.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
More like if you covered yourself in soap, that's what it would feel like.
No, but like it would be squishier. Like that's if you just like,
I don't know.
No, Vaseline. Show and
just got gooed.
it's like a thick soap is what it feels like.
Oh, I was going to say, it's like rubbing Vaseline on you.
Yeah.
Oh, like
Oh,
Vix.
God. Vix first just that covered in Vaseline.
That's, yep. That's not completely nasty or anything. Basically,
when Halo leaves your body, you will have, like, prune skin.
Oh, yeah. I do slowly dissolve stuff when I touch him. That's a lot of the reason why I'm in the jar.
Oh, God.
I roll a perception check just to kind of, as we're going, to see.
Go for it.
I rolled a 16 plus 6.
Okay, 16 plus 6? Okay. So, Jesus. Okay. So, as you're kind of just walking on through, you see the sheep. He's kind of just trotting along, not too much going on in front of him. fuck, what was that? 16 plus 6? 22?
Yeah. Yep.
Dang, girl. Okay. Okay, so as you're trotting up along, the sheep kind of hops over.
There you go.
Look, I rolled a nat 20 all the time. Always 20.
That would be wait, amazing. I'd be really impressed.
Okay, so he's trotting along, and you can see that he's actually trotting over some wires that are walking up towards you are very quickly approaching. There's a big trip wire on the ground.
Oh.
Hello. Can we try and break it?
That's up to you.
Break the tripwire?
Well, I'm trying to think.
The tripwire, you can see that there is a something curled over on one of the trees. There's like a large branch-looking thing that's kind of curled out onto the trees that's connected down to the tripwire.
Who is good with traps?
I mean, I have a sleight of hand.
Deception kits, if you have any of them.
I have a tinker tool. I don't think that helps, though.
So. I don't have any.
My deception is -1, so
that Jesus.
Help. I have good perception. I have like a really good perception, good perception.
Deception.
Oh, deception. I have a +3 in deception.
There you go.
If you want to try it, go for it. What do you want to do then?
I could try to disarm it.
Okay.
Okay, I'll go do a roll then.
Go for it.
Ooh, hello there. A nat 20.
All right, well, you walk up over to the trap.
I crawl over because I'm a slime.
Oh, right, sorry. You crawl over to the trap. The sheep kind of stops, and he's like, oh, by the way, there's trap. Oh, you're already doing it. Okay. He kind of you just gracefully grab the trap, pull the wires apart, and you take it apart in such a way that the branch that was hanging kind of falls into the grass, or into the, like, the overgrowth that was sitting there. It was a large tree branch with a few spikes hanging on top of it, so luckily you didn't trap, set that off, because you would have caught a spike to the chest or something. Would have been joyous.
Okay, oh, no.
Anyways, oh, yeah. I forgot to mention, there was one of those traps. I'll let you know in the future.
Great, thanks. Thanks for letting us know. Thanks. That was really helpful.
Okay. Anyway. Anyways, yeah. So he's, let's continue. Come on. We gotta be like sheeps passing in the night. And it is... What? It's kind of dark out. I'd say it's currently about... right, about like an hour or two before evening, before dusk. All right, okay. So you guys are wandering on off. Thankfully, he pointed out the rest of the traps that you guys got through. He disarmed a few of them himself because, I mean, he did help set them. It's his area, and he looks over. So you guys can see that there's a large, just a big, large open area sitting out there, and you can see there's brush right where the opening is, so... If you guys want to duck into that, you can, but you're currently sitting in a big open area, and there seems to be something of buildings kind of just hanging and floating, sitting there. There's three kind of rooms. There's one sitting close to the ground, one hanging a little bit up top, and then there's a big central one, a big room that's sitting there, and they're all sitting on big variations of tree stumps and whatnot. And you see a few things kind of wandering around there.
Then we should What do you guys think we should do? I'm letting others lead.
Okay. I think you guys should just decide.
God damn it. All right.
The sheep sits there and is like, maybe you should look around a bit.
Should I roll a perception check?
If you'd like.
If I need... Well, if to look around, do I need to roll? Or am I just looking around?
No, you don't need to roll for that.
Okay.
Good,
because I rolled a 2, and that would have sucked.
Hey, I rolled a 3. Okay, so you can kind of see that there are a few different things. There's some monkeys that are sitting out right in the kind of like the big open pathway. You can see that there's actually an outhouse underneath the biggest building, and you can see that the outhouse.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
Through everyone. You can see that this is kind of like big tree stumps that have this large tree that's keeping all of the kind of like the rooms are kind of like on branches interconnected together to the big one. There's pathways up to the first one, pathway up to the large room, and then there's also a pathway coming from the large room to the other exterior room sitting there.
Let's go to the large room.
You can only get up through going through the small room first and heading on through.
Through the small room. Yeah.
Alright.
I don't want to do that. Yeah, let's just go through the small room.
Okay. If you'd like to.
Is there anything with the door? Like, is it just a normal door? We just open it and go?
Okay, as you were walking up the two monkeys, I guess it'd be better to say apes, but either way. Monkeys.
Same thing, right?
More or less. No. The apes are sitting there, and they kind of look for something. The two apes are kind of sitting there. They're very carefully watching you. And they have, like I said, they have great swords sitting in the ground next to them, so they're kind of sitting right next to it.
Can I go over and say hi?
Well, you guys still have that animal.
Well, I can speak to animals.
Oh, that's right. But you guys also have that scroll still in effect.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'll just go, what up, my brother?
So,
wow.
What's up with everybody calling everybody brother?
That was really racist. No. Okay, so the apes are kind of sitting there like, who are you? What are you doing? And one of them's kind of, one of them just sitting there like clutching his greatsword, the greatsword's in the ground, and he's kind of just sitting there like, who are you? What are you doing?
Well, as you can tell, I'm a bear.
Yeah, we have many bears out here. What's your point?
So we're trying to just we're just trying to meet our friend. He's a half orc.
Guz?
Yeah, that guy. Guz. He's our friend.
He just came back. He was really really beaten up. Do you know what happened to him?
Yeah, there were some guys. We were trying to protect them, but we got lost as we were fighting through the people.
Better roll a persuasion check for that one.
Well, that is an 8. I'm pretty sure that did not work.
No, because I rolled a crit fail. Okay.
Oh, damn!
Okay.
Why should he roll rules?
that's good. Did you help Guz? He's a good guy. He's just really under a lot of pressure right now, you know?
Is your boss pretty, Is he a good guy or is he not so good?
He's what's Halo say? Here's Gumi. Oh god,
the link you posted.
God damn it, Halo. If we can't keep it PG, we're not keeping it at all.
His original picture was that of Sue from Monster Masume, so that's like just even worse.
Eh, whatever.
Was it?
Whatever. Okay, so
what is that even?
Monster Musume?
Yeah, I don't even know what that is.
Bullshit.
It's basically hentai.
Don't.
Bull. Anyway, so
it's basically hentai.
Hen, listen, come here. I'm gonna smack you with this. All right. So the apes kind of sit there and they're like, "Oh, he's a pretty good guy. I mean, he pays us okay, but we have good food. He did kind of polymorph us into these apes, but it's a good life. I'm much more nimble now. Thank you, Bay City. Yeah, and the other ape just kind of sits there and he's trying to, he's pretty good boss. Mm-hmm. I like him. I like him a lot. He gives us big bushels of bananas every now and then.
What?
He said bananas.
Bushels of bananas.
Oh.
What? Do I want to know what you thought he said?
If you want, but no.
Okay. Well, thanks for the information. We're just gonna head up and say hi.
Oh, I don't think you should do that. That's kind of. He's very stressed out.
Well, we're here to help him in any way that we can.
As you're sitting there talking to him, a bear walks out of the outhouse.
Kind of
just stumbles on out there, and he stumbles.
Is it the same one?
He stumbles on out there. God, Hen, you're gonna make me have to reset this again, really?
What?
Oh, okay, never mind.
No, I tried it, but then I was like, nah, you're gonna have to reset it, so.
Yeah, it's all right. Okay, so yeah, the bear walks out and he's like, "Oh, you guys, I guess since you're still talking to him, he walks out. Oh, you guys, you're again. What are you doing here?
I'm just here to see our friend Gus. He's cool.
What happened to the sheep?
I don't know. It's really, I don't know what happened to it. And I look at who's holding the sheep. Hen, right?
No, the sheep's kind of standing on his own.
Yeah, the sheep's kind of just chilling.
I just kind of grab my foot and just kind of secretly push the sheep behind us. And sure, just kind of push him back a little bit, and he's out of eyesight.
Well, the sheep that was I grabbed it and he poofed, he disappeared.
Oh, you know what? I have something for you, buddy. And I'd use minor summoning again and summon a sheep.
Really? Okay.
It's a cantrip.
Oh, that's right. You can use as much as you want.
Yeah.
That has too much like magic shit. Oh my god.
That's what casters do, man. Cantrips are.
Yeah.
Cantrips that's aren't my... really for combat. They're like deceiving people and helping things.
It can be for combat, but it's really not. It's like really less combat.
Yeah, like the majority of it is not really.
I have like two combat spells. All the rest of them are utility and healing.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
No.
I have two spells.
Yeah.
Okay. So the bear is sitting there. Like, oh, we got it. And you kind of just hear him like roar. But I mean, to you guys, you hear, "We got it, guys."
Is he gonna eat the sheep?
No, he yells out.
Thank God. Yeah. I'm about to feel so bad.
He yells out to Gus, and the two apes kind of jump up and they're like, "Oh, there's the sheep! There's the sheep! Oh God, we got it!" And they both grab him and they run. They haul ass right up the pathway into the first building, second building, into the main building.
It lasts 10 minutes, by the way.
10 minutes. Oh God, that's gonna be fun. Okay. The bear sister's like, "Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much."
You're welcome. Do you mind if we come with you? Can we come with you?
Yeah. Yeah, help you. You helped us get the sheep. Yeah, you come on. And he kind of like motions this way.
All right.
He's a bear that can walk on two legs, kind of like you. He's not a bear kin type thing, but he's just a bear that's oddly humanoid shaped.
Mowgli. What's his name? Mowgli. No, that's
Bear Necessity.
Yeah,
Baloo.
Baloo. Thank you. There you go.
No, Mowgli was the kid.
I haven't seen it so long. Okay. So, guys, you ready to go up?
Okay, in the, okay, are you guys just gonna walk on up there?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Cool.
I mean, yeah.
Alright, so the, alright. The first building, the smaller one that's sitting there that you have to pass through, is kind of like an open area. There's more earth on the ground, there's... It looks like small patches that you can grow food and things like that. There's trees and whatnot. As you go up into the second one, you hit on the door, you open it, and it's kind of like this. It's a large living area slash barracks slash storage area. It's an all-in-one type place. And you can see that right in the center is this... excuse me. Jesus Christ. No.
Right, so, in the center is Jesus Christ?
Yeah, he's actually sitting there, and he's...
Oh, well, that's, you know. Interesting.
Yeah, yeah. No. okay, so...
Katie, you're screwed, run!
No, it's just my throat is fucking hurting. oh my god.
Oh, wait. So, okay, so actually, one thing I want to do, while this is going on, since we're entering the building, I want Gumi to slowly, like, go off to the side and start climbing up the wall.
Yeah, don't you have spider crawl as like a thing?
Yeah, I could climb up walls and onto ceilings.
Okay, gotcha.
Oh yeah, a gunslinger on the top would be really nice.
Yeah, that's so yeah, weird. I'm just gonna take my guns and I'm gonna just slowly crawl my way up.
Slime, come on.
yes, I'm a gunslinger slime. You got a problem with that?
All right, okay.
I guess so. So you see that there's this small man sitting in the center. He's kind of scribbling hastily, and he kind of like jumped up because he saw that the bear first, of course, came, or the two monkeys came in with the sheep, and he's kind of sitting there. He's kind of just like looking right at the sheep and whatnot. You guys have the other one still, right?
Yeah. He's kind of behind. I kind of like hit him a bit behind us.
Okay, gotcha.
Wait, the real one or the fake one?
The real one. They took the fake one up with them wherever they went.
Yeah, it's a real animal. It's just
it poofs away after real, 10 minutes.
Like behind me, I'm giant.
What?
I'll just hold the real one, just like behind me. I'm a big thing.
Sure.
Oh, that's right. You are a fucking minotaur.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So I realize this is the first thing I'm going to literally do the entire time.
Besides just follow everybody.
That's no exaggeration. I haven't actually done anything.
Okay.
Damn it.
Right, then. Well, he's kind of sitting there like staring at the sheep, and the monkeys are kind of just sitting there like, oh, yeah, we did good. We did good, huh? We did good. And they're kind of just bouncing up and down. He's staring and peering at the sheep. Hearing and just sitting there, and he pulls out a small wand, and he kind of just like taps it on the sheep, and the sheep disappears.
You made my sheep go away. How dare you?
And Guz is sitting there, the half orc, and he's kind of sitting like on a chair. He's just a little he got a bit of a wound mark sitting there right in his armor where you caught him with your fucking great axe.
Saying Cadian looks over across the arms just like, yo.
He's sitting there and so the wizard, he goes, I am Master Noak, and I need the sheep. I know you have it. I know you have it. Oh goddamn.
Why?
Yeah.
Why?
For a long time, hurts. I need that sheep. That sheep is very, very important to me. I will take it from force if have to.
Why?
You do not understand what will happen. I just need that sheep.
Why? What is the purpose?
That will happen because you won't fucking tell us.
And you know what, Guz? Go for it. Roll initiative, everyone.
All right.
Well, roll initiative. Okay.
Hey, crit 20.
Jesus. What a great time to roll crit 20.
My first 17 plus 2, so 19.
16.
Dang. Okay, so we have, let's see, who do we have? We currently have Noak.
We have Halo. You need to roll initiative.
Oh, yeah, roll initiative? Okay.
Well, does he? If he's like,
I mean, he's technically sitting outside of the place, so not yet. But you can if you want to. I don't know. That's if you want to do like a stealth attack or something.
So I got 15, but I get a plus 2 initiative, so 17.
Okay, gotcha. Okay, so Noak, he just straight runs off. He just instantly dashes off out the other door, up towards the other area. the third little building. Straight up, 100% just phew, gone. Guz is getting up, and the two apes are kind of sitting there. All right. What was everyone's initiative? I know you guys all rolled high.
I got 17.
16.
Okay. Jesus. Okay.
Okay.
All right.
And I got...
I mean, that is useless on
I got a 19.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Okay.
All right. Guz is kind of sitting there just like, oh, God, not again. And he kind of just... He just kind of like slowly gets up with his great sword, and he's like, all right, let's do this. And he just kind of sits there with it, holding on. The two apes are kind of just hooting and hollering. They have their great swords, and they're sitting there waiting.
Are they in entering combat as well?
Yeah, everyone that's currently
Yeah, I was going to say. Henzoid has a point. Let's not start the battle yet. Let's take like a 10-minute break.
All right, guys. So we saw that the battle is... we are going to be unfolding the battle in a second. We'll be back for a good... We'll be back in a good 5 minutes.
Suspense. Can you like put up like a picture of like... you know, those old, like, we'll be right back.
I used to have one like that.
We'll be right back.
I had one of those from Fallout.
Oh, yeah, like the Fallout screen, where it's like, we'll be back shortly. And it's like the error screens they used to show on old televisions.
Let's see.
Let's do this one. This is the one from Monty Python.
No, nothing with music that could be.
No, nothing. Yeah, it can't be a video. It's just a still image.
How about just a big middle finger, and then it says, we'll be back.
Well, that, we'd have to make that, unless you could find that.
How about...
I'm sure it's somewhere.
Hold on, I got this, don't worry. I got this.
Oh, just put up, like, Fallout, like, we'll be right back, or transmission, something.
Look, don't worry, man. I got this. Where the fuck is the... Where's the thing I literally just saved? Oh god, I don't know where I saved it to. There it is. Okay, cool. I can't find this picture. I guess there we go. Okay, there you go. We will be right back.
Oh, pictures.
Yeah, I put it. It'll take a second. All right, guys.
Oh, that's a good
one. Oh yeah, the Fallout. There we go.
All right, be back in about 5-10 minutes.
Yep.
So, how you guys doing in chat, huh? Just doing good? Good? Is that a Gab I hear?
No.
Gab, did you see the new command that Hen made?
No. What did he make? Where is it?
It's called Gooey Goomy.
I don't even want to click this. Why? Why? Why did he do a GIF from Monster Moves May?
He did it. That's all I know.
Play Overwatch while we're waiting. Ugh.
Well, I'm nowhere near my PS4.
I got nothing from the winter thing yet.
I got several things.
I haven't played. I played like a minute, and that's about it.
Oh. So you opened your default thing, and that's it.
I opened 2 loot crates, loot boxes, and I got jack all.
Oh.
I just want Lucio. I think I only want Lucio, because that's really the only one I play out of the new skins.
You don't want Tracer and her adorable elf costume?
I I hate Tracer. She is cancer. I refuse to play Tracer.
Cheers, love. Calvary's here.
Go away, Henzoid. Nobody wants you here.
Oh man, the pizza I just got is actually hot and spicy.
Maybe you shouldn't be a wuss about it. Oh, never mind. I have two boxes to open, apparently. Let's see what I'm about to open. Alright. Alright, I'm opening. I got Jack nothing! Yay!
What are you opening?
An adorable fire ornament. A watch. Okay. And I have one more box.
I am repositioning myself on this bed. Because
wow, I got Jack all in this entire thing.
My first box I got May's emote.
Awesome. I got a Yeti.
So I ended up getting Widowmaker's highlight intro with the mistletoe.
I haven't gotten Symmetra or anything. I want Symmetra stuff. Are we...
Now, time for the sexy hour with Damon and Geb.
Hey, Henzoid.
Hey, man.
Oh, God.
How you doing?
Oh, Jesus, no.
I'm doing great.
My boner is too strong. I need to charge this thing. I started playing Magic again. Does anybody play Magic?
Uh huh.
Damn Water God.
Stop. I got
specifically so no one can use it.
I got some new decks and I love them.
I haven't played in years.
You should play. I have a Necromancy deck. I love it.
I don't have the. The funds available to devote to Magic.
Oh, that's true. Oh, if you were here, I'd give you... I have, like, a box filled. I started a... This is my deck. And it's a Necromancy deck. I love it. Oh, wait. Man, come to Florida. This thing... It's filled with Magic cards.
I had... Okay. Is that a single sleeve, like single width cards?
Yeah.
I had, at the height of my collection, I had 12 of those filled.
Nice. I have that, box this about this big that has like three layers, and then I have a Tupperware that's about... Three layers this way, and then three layers this way.
When I was in the height of my collection, I was working in the Walmart deli, and we would get American cheese in boxes that were perfect for putting cards in. So I would end up with a big box with six little sleeve boxes that were perfect for Magic cards. So I had two of those big boxes that had six sleeves that were each about that size, all filled. And this was, I'm talking back when, you know, Odyssey, Torment, Judgment, way back before before the card redesign.
I have, for a while ago, Amazon had a thing of just black cards. So I was like, ooh, let's see what I got. And it was all the old as hell deck. I was like, yes.
Way back in like Arabian Nights and... Yeah. All of them. You probably didn't have many that were alpha beta. But...
No, I was really happy because I wanted the original box, and I was like, "Yep."
Yeah. Nope. I know a guy who he posted a video on YouTube, but he's from my area. he had an original unwrapped alpha deck.
Jesus.
Of what?
And
magic.
Of magic, oh, nice. Magic cards. And he opened it on camera. And it was, back then, those decks, they weren't pre-made. There were random bits to them.
Mm. Yeah.
And back in Alpha, there were, I think, 7 cards that were the ultimate cards and the most rare and the most sought-after cards in the game. And he got one of them.
Jesus.
If it was a Black Lotus, I mean, that's the most expensive.
Nope. Oh, okay. Ruby Mox.
Yeah, the Mox items.
Mox. He got a Ruby Mox. Or a Mox Ruby, and that card is like something like a $400 card.
And last I checked, it was closer to a grand, but yeah.
Yeah, but he got it mint condition, fresh out of a sealed alpha deck.
Jesus. Yeah, I was
with,
just.
Sorry, but fix my face, Enzoid says.
Ew, no. We're done.
I want to get back into it. I have 12 decks now.
Jesus,
so I was
girl.
Like, yeah, I have a zombie deck, a vampire deck, a necromancer deck.
That hen.
My elves are my main.
When I was doing tournaments, I had a red green gruel deck, and I was beast mode on that thing, and I was top decking like no one's business.
White and red, I'm just not into. I'm more of a soul tie person.
I'm like, green red. I'll give me some green minion rush and some red burn spells, and I'm just
My red green is landfall, and I ended up playing against my friend. my creature ended up being it was like 30-30 against her dragon, and she was like, "Oh yeah, I got my dragon out," and I'm like, "Oh well, my scythe leopard now has 30-30 attack, so." Sorry.
Damn, girl.
Way back when the card redesign first came out, I had a deck that was built on a mechanic that they had back then for artifacts that they don't have now. And I forget what the mechanic was called, but for every different color mana you use in the summoning of this thing, it would get a charge.
Mm. Yep.
And Starburst, I think it was, something like that. Yeah. I don't
know. Or Chromatic. There's, or something like that.
The counters and charge and stuff is coming back. I think
yeah.
Kaladesh, but I think, has a bunch of counters.
There was a creature that you could use that and it would come out as a 5/5, and every turn you could tap it to double the number of counters on it.
Jesus.
And so I got to the point where it was like, yeah, I'm attacking you with a, let's see, I have an 80-80 that's coming straight at your face. And by the way, it has trample. And they're just like, yeah, I'm done.
Well, I surrender.
Although, I got banned from the casual groups in my high school for playing Magic. Because we had these rules for casual groups. Mana Rush, 7-card Blitz, and Mana Blitz.
Yeah.
Fun.
So, Mana Rush, you can play every land in your hand at the same time. 7-card Blitz, when you start your turn, you draw till 7. You play any lands, you can draw back until 7. So I built a deck that was 40 lands and 10 X damage burn spells.
See, Hen's trying to look as stupid as possible right now.
We freaking remember when we played it with our friends, the couple that we know.
What about them?
I played, my main deck is Elf. So we ended up playing, and I had, what did I have, like 30 elves out in the field?
Oh my god, oh, I yeah. hate elf.
And I elf had decks. I had a goat spam deck, so I could constantly summon an army of goats.
Dude, if we played our decks with each other against somebody, oh my god, we would have like 60 creatures out on the field just destroy people.
Goats on goats on goats.
We need to do that, and the elves are riding the goats into the battle.
Oh god. Okay. So is everyone ready?
The best play that I ever saw, there was a creature back in Torment that was a vampire that if it dealt damage to a player, that player lost. And I was playing a bird deck at the time, and in my deck, I had a spell that, an instant that if I had a bird on the field, I could sacrifice that bird and redirect an attack from an attacking creature back to that creature's owner.
guys, real quickly, look at the stream and at Hen's picture.
his webcam froze, so that's why.
I know, but then, like, look at how it froze.
We're keeping it. I don't care.
Yeah, I have Vraska, so her final one is she summons three assassins.
That's right.
And if they attack the person, they automatically lose.
And yep. I was just happy with my Infect Dex. That's all I cared about.
Infect Dex is great. We got to play again.
No, we don't.
I'll bring them Wednesday. We're gonna play.
Really don't need to. Okay.
I have a bunch of decks that are like we need. Decks.
Are we back live? We're back live.
We've been live. We've
been back
whole
live
time.
For like forever.
Oh, okay.
I didn't turn.
We never stopped being live.
Henzoid dropped the call.
Hen, what the fudge?
The stream's gonna get screwed up again.
What the fudge, bro? Okay, there you go. He's gone. Hen just doesn't even get a picture now.
Art. It looks like I'm still trying to grab him from the side.
Oh god, the deck is fuck it all up. Yeah, it did.
It did.
Okay, god damn it.
It says his Wi-Fi got turned off.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Alright, well.
Is he coming back?
Oh god, everything's all fucked up.
Oh my god.
No god. Oh god. Got rid of the overlay. God, man, why do you do this?
That screwed everything up. You know what? It's time to post that GIF I found.
And, god damn it, it's all your fault. Okay, well, no, you're still on there. That's fine, Halo.
Oh, god. What happened? What's going on?
I'm just going to currently put our pictures up until he figures out if he's coming back or not.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have my avatar, right?
Somewhere. I have no fucking clue where. Let's see. I think I have Twitch under all my Twitch shit.
No, I'm on my laptop, actually, so I can't even get it.
That's fine. Actually, no, I currently don't.
Let's see if that works. I invited him, or not? Nope, he's busy. Cool. Way to suck.
Great. This stream, we just died.
We spent too long talking about magic. The stream decided we did had enough and canceled it.
Are you back?
He joined.
Yeah.
Are you actually back?
I'm actually back. It that time it was just my Wi-Fi just like turning off.
Okay.
Oh, God, my bronchitis again.
Let's see. Here you go. Come on, work. Why didn't it work?
Well, for the time being, I can put you back on. That's no problem.
There you go.
Oh, thank you.
Literally just went to my YouTube page and downloaded my profile picture.
Oh, well, yo, there you go.
Carl is so salty.
Carl is always salty.
Oh, yeah, because that's totally what Mr. Day is. Thank you.
What?
Carl's a salty girl.
Woods just almost put Mr. Day as Hen.
Now I'm putting Geb as Halo.
Oh. Okay, put me as Witsy then.
No, we need someone with a miraculous beard for Geb. That.
Yeah, my beard's diminished.
It's okay. That's okay, my friend.
Yeah, no, just have a tiger, just Geb. Just Geb. We don't need anyone else. We all need this Geb.
Okay. We will just, we'll put Geb in every picture.
Yeah, put Geb in every picture.
No, I'm good. No one wants to see that. Alright, so are we good? Hen, are you good to be back on this?
No, yeah.
No, Amnesiac, look, he says all Geb, see? Boom, Geb for everyone.
Alright guys, Geb percent.
All the hypno Geb.
We're gonna be doing Geb percent.
Oh my god, I need a picture of Geb so that I can make that a hypno Geb.
Don't put Geb in all of them. Just put Geb as the whole stream.
I think if
just the entire stream.
I think this
just Geb.
Just cover it with just one picture of
Hold on. Does this fix it? Let me know.
I can't even see the stream.
Does this fix it, guys? Let me know. Just let me know if this fixes it. All right, we good?
Yes, that fixes everything.
All right, cool.
Wait. What? Oh, I haven't caught up yet. Oh, well, yeah, fixes everything.
Hold on.
I also have not caught up because I'm watching it on mobile.
Actually, there we go. Don't worry. We're good.
No, don't worry. Don't worry. It's perfect. Oh, no. You ruined it.
You ruined it. What's right.
A... Soiled it.
All right. I guess so. People are in. Hey, people stayed. That's surprising. All right. Let's do it. All right. So what the fuck was happening?
We're about to battle.
Why would we battle?
Oh, yeah, we're about to battle.
All right, does everyone remember their initiative? Also, Hen, send me some answer. Yeah.
Let's see.
Mine was 17.
I'm 16.
And 20. I had 19.
Oh, dang. I forgot 20. All of mine, so hold on. How many do we have? We have two apes. We have Guz. Is that it? I think that's it.
What about
And then Noak Gunner. Noak ran like
the
hell.
Wizard. The wizard got the hell out of there, yeah.
Oh, he did?
He ran straight out. He's total bitch mode. all right, cool.
Oh. He looked at his henchman that was already, like, almost cleaved in two and said, you deal with this.
Yeah.
Skyrim Wolf is saying, where's your hat, Day?
Oh.
Okay, cool.
Or should I put on this?
Well, the crab's Day's
we
hat.
We can't hear you to put that on.
Yeah, and I can't breathe when I put this on, so...
Yeah, don't do it. Okay. I am the initiative, okay. All right, guys, so let us go. The order is... 1, 2, 3, and then 4. Yeah, okay, cool. All right, so let us start up. So they're getting their... The two apes have got their great swords. Guz is sitting there with his great sword as well, and they are sitting there ready to go, watching you.
All right, so
watching
Ham has to go first.
Someone I'm actually Puzzle Mage.
How can I? Does anybody check how fast they are?
They're all standard speed, 30 feet, so.
Okay, because I want to charge right at it. Like, charge.
Don't you have that as, like, a thing you can do?
Yeah, but, like, a Minotaur's charge, I can't turn while I'm charging.
So you just go in one straight line.
Yeah, and if they dodge out of the way, I just kind of crash into something.
That could be fun.
And it's at 70 speed, so...
Jesus.
Well...
Yeah, you're like, Minotaur, you're kind of raging.
But yeah, I'm going to charge at him.
Alright, do we need to dodge for that, or what?
Yeah, probably.
Okay. All right. I guess. I guess. Roll for the charge. So I have something to roll against.
Wait. What do I roll?
D20.
Oh crap! I closed my dice thing.
I guess do that and add. Since it's a charge, I guess add your strength modifier. I don't know. Unless you have something in your character sheet that tells you about it.
Are you sure I shouldn't do something with speed? Because, like, I don't know.
Well, I mean, if you're moving at more than twice the normal speed, it's going to be hard to dodge out either way.
So roll 1d20 and then add strength. Okay.
Yeah, go for it. Why not?
Okay. Oh, God. I got a 7. And then... So, 11. Oh, no, wait.
Well, I'm at disadvantage because you're running twice as fast as me.
So not 11. Wait. 14.
Okay, so 14. And what are you... which one are you charging?
The left one?
There's two apes and a Guz.
Oh, Guz.
You want to charge Guz? All right, yeah. He's definitely
poor Guz.
He's definitely already at disadvantage because of everything that's going on there.
Yep.
Yeah.
Someone should just tell Guz just to give up.
Okay. As you charge him, he's sitting there with his sword. You can just, right before you hit him, you can just faintly hear, "Oh, not again." Okay, charge, do a... I guess do a damage roll.
What? Isn't that what I just did? Oh.
No, that was a roll to see if it'll hit me and everything. I guess you're gonna like gore me with your horns or something.
Mm-hmm.
What? Don't your horns have an attack rolls on them or something?
D4, D6.
I'd say it's a D4, D6 probably.
1d4 and 1d6?
No, like either or.
It's either a d4 or a d6. I'd say a d6.
Yeah, two big horns and a tar probably. So roll 2d6.
Okay, 6 and 1. So 7.
7 damage? Okay, well.
Should you apply a strength modifier though?
Yeah.
For horns. So yeah, then, I guess so.
14. Again.
14?
Yeah. Oh.
Boy, this fucking orc is not having a good day. All right. You, as you run with such force that you just pick him right up with your horns, crash him right into the wall, and you go through the frail wall that was sitting right behind him. And Guz is now knocked out prone, not very happy, but very, very tired of everyone's shit. And he is currently laying down there. And the two apes are just kind of looking incredulously at what just happened.
Don't kill Guz. I've found a respect for him if he survived this much. I have respect for him now.
I really hope that there's a plot twist where he's actually the kid that got traumatized.
Look, just go.
Look. Okay. This isn't directed by M. Night Shyamalan, okay?
No, God, no. All of a sudden, they find out the monster is all of you.
Who was next? That would be, let's see, Hadn't got a 20, I got a 19, so...
I got 16.
Okay, I'm taking...
Day's next, and then I'm after Day.
Well, I don't know if you're going to get to do much. I got my double attack and going after two apes.
I mean, if you can't really move and attack at the same time, so you'll get one attack off of one nearest to you. But you won't be able to move and get the other guy at the same time.
Yeah, remember, this is a large room, so you could run up to him. Oh, okay. You could, since you could do a second attack, you could maybe run up and do one attack instead of two.
Okay, yeah. Why don't I do that? I'll move to one of the guys and then do an attack.
Okay. Roll that AC check.
Oh, PK finally showed up. Uh-oh. Took him long.
Let's see. 14 plus...
You hit either way.
Plus 6, so I got a 20.
Yeah, you hit either way. All right, what's your...
Okay.
What's that attack?
2d12 plus 3. I got a 7 plus 13.
13? Alright. So you run up, and the apes are still kind of sitting there terrified because a minotaur just ran through their wall with Guz. And you catch one on the side with the axe, you just thump, and you catch him right on the side, it cleaves right on into him, and you just launch him as it kind of slices out him, and he just flies a good 10, 15 feet. Oh my god!
Batting practice.
It's beautiful. It's definitely beautiful. Let's see. Can we do that? No, that's me. That's that. That's that. That. There we go.
Okay.
all right. Who's next?
Oh, I keep forgetting to do the that aura check or aura concentration at the start
Vortex.
Of my turn.
If you'd like to, that I mean, that's up to you.
Nah. Yeah, I'm next. On the list.
All right, do it.
Okay, go, Halo.
All right, so I guess Gumi gonna materialize for who's on top of the ceiling. By the way, she made her way up there during this entire confrontation.
Okay.
And she's gonna take her pistol and she's gonna use an ability of hers called what's it called again?
Oh, that's a cool ability.
Sniper's Mark.
All right.
So what you do is I could target a creature. And I get an advantage on attack rolls until the creature is either a minute has passed or the creature is dead.
Gotcha. Okay.
Okay, and so that'll make it easier for me to hit it. All right. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna.
And what are you targeting?
I'm gonna target the other monkey.
Okay. Go for it.
All right, and then I
was gonna say there's only one thing left.
Yeah. Well, both aren't dead. They're just launched off.
Oh.
Okay, so I rolled a
D10. Why am I black screened on the stream?
You were having an issue with someone over there, so I guess black screen you so you weren't, like, you know, so you weren't distracting.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Yep.
Looking sister.
Okay, so what you doing? You taking aim, you shooting?
Yeah, so I in total rolled, I think it's a 14 total.
Okay, is that the for the?
That's my damage. That's my damage in total.
Well, you have to also. You still have to do the AC roll to see if you actually hit. Because remember, it's like you have advantage to that. So you roll two. You take the best of the two.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So roll. Wait, so I rolled another D20.
Roll a D20 twice, and you take the best of the two.
All right, I got a 15 and a 12, so I guess I go with the 15.
Okay, so yeah, you hit.
And then do I have, like, apply any modifiers, or is it good?
You hit either way.
It hits either way, yeah.
Okay.
All right,
so...
And what was the damage we were doing?
14.
Okay, so you currently sitting upside down on this ceiling, take aim, and with a very loud bang, everyone hears the ape just kind of crumples down, and he is also in a prone position. He is not dead, but he
crumples.
But
I hate that word.
Currently has, you know, a very large bullet lodged through his chest, so he is currently sitting there.
Incapacitated.
All right, is Geb going now, or?
Yeah, it's my turn.
All right, go for it.
I think I'll do spike growth.
Okay, what's that?
I can make a giant, like, spike grow from the ground. It's like hard spikes and thorns.
That's terrifying.
And if a creature moves within the area, it takes 2d4 piercing damage for every 5 feet it travels.
Take it. Okay, so is it pretty much you just pop a spot and then anywhere that you walk into? Okay.
Yeah.
Does it have a certain range within you can cast it?
It has a 20-foot radius.
20-foot radius? Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, because so I guess you're just dropping it as like a Caltrops type thing in front of you? Okay.
How far away are the two from each other?
They, since both, the ape that Halo shot was about 30 feet away, and the one that Day launched is now about 60 feet away.
I will put it right into, I'll move up 10 feet, I have 30 movement.
Right.
And I'll set it down right next to him. Okay. So
right next to the one this guest sitting on the ground?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
So it should be... if he's in the training, he takes 2d4 piercing damage.
Damn. Okay. Let's see.
Where's my... Well, it's only 2d4, so I mean, that could be 2 damage.
That's true. let's see. What do we have? We have 3... and 2, so he takes 5 damage, actually. So, that actually kills him. You pull up this grove, and it, all of a sudden, these big thorns just pierce through it, and the ape kind of sits there hanging on one of them. The thorn just kind of goes up, pierces right through the ape, and he's just sitting, hanging on the
That's horrifying.
Thorn. Kinda, yeah.
Does it have a... Okay, yeah. Alright. That's all I can do. All
right. So
maybe I'll move back. Maybe I'll move back.
Well, you already moved
once. So.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Yeah, we can only do that once.
I thought you could do if you have 30 feet. I thought you could move and then move again. Oh, I guess not. I'm wrong.
You can only take one move action per turn.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Thank you.
Okay. So that is what's currently going on.
Huh? Otherwise, told.
Yeah. Yeah.
I know there's some classes that let you have an extra move action.
Yeah, like monks have like extra bonus movement, things like that.
If the monkey tries to go through that area, by the way,
he takes the same.
It's he takes the same for every 5 feet he moves, and it's difficult terrain.
Oh, so it cuts it in half then. So yeah.
Yeah.
How big is that radius?
20 feet.
Oh damn. Okay. So either way, he's taking at least 2 hits. Damn.
Yeah.
Okay. So
if he wants to come to us.
So, well, I mean, it is also... Yeah, no, you're in a fucking building. There's not too much area around
that.
And how long does that last for?
10 minutes.
Oh, God. Okay.
It's a second level spell.
Okay, so Guz is sitting there, and he kind of pushes Iramir off of him since he, you know, toppled over onto him. He kind of pushes him, and he's sitting there. He kind of gets up, and he takes his greatsword, and he... Your AC is 14, right? 10?
11.
11? Okay, well, either way, that was a miss. Because of everything that's happened, he is very, very wary. He kind of takes his greatsword, and he swings and just completely misses you. just 100% swings at the ground, and he just kind of, it thuds, and he just kind of sighs. Ugh. And the
well
other,
done.
The other
just,
ape,
just knock him out.
The other ape kind of, he hops up, and he starts, he's within a movement area to you, and he runs into the briar patch. Because he is not really thinking. Where the fuck that?
Well, it's actually camouflage. So if he didn't see it come up, it's camouflage, and he has to make a wisdom saving throw.
Right. Well, I mean,
a perception check.
Oh, okay. Well, I
if
mean,
like if he wants to see,
if no, he's kind of in a rage. He's just running, okay. And hopping in.
Okay.
Okay. So let's see. And then you said 2d4.
Yeah, 2d4 for every 5 feet.
Okay, so he runs in, and of course he doesn't notice, and the briars just catch up onto him, and he just sitting there, and he's just kind of rip, you know, trying to rip himself through, and he's caught in the center of the briar patch. And actually, hold on. And he is actually done. So he tries and runs through and rips up, and he just collapses right in the middle of these thorn patches. Right next
that
to
was
him.
A good spell.
He gets impaled as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad I picked that one.
And then, yeah, Guz is just kind of sitting there, just heaving heavily, like.
So just cock him over the head, Hen, and just knock him out.
No, I look at no before.
Stab him with my battle axe.
No. Before you do that, I look at Guz and I look at him and I say, "Hey, Guz, would you like to work with us?"
He just kind of looks over at you for a minute. It's like, roll a persuasion for that.
That is a 17.
17. Okay. He sits there. And he kind of with his sword sitting there on the ground right next to Day, he looks for a second. He looks over to you. It's like,
I have curing magic, so I can heal you.
Nope, doesn't pay me enough. And he kind of just like throws it back up on his back, and he just falls and sits down on the ground. And he's just like, I throw in the towel. I'm done.
Do you want me to heal you, or are you good?
Please, oh God, please.
Please heal you? All right. No, he's a hired help.
Yeah, I'm just a mercenary from Noak.
How much health does
we
he
don't
have?
Need him.
He currently how much health? He currently
take a
only
vote.
Has
we
33.
Out of how much?
67.
I will cast Cure Wounds then.
Okay, go for it.
No, we take a vote on this first.
You can. I'm just doing
you
it.
You guys really want to, yeah.
No, you can't, because I'm gonna help him. Dude, he's a mercenary.
Well,
like,
I
he
mean,
doesn't...
they could take a vote, but in the meantime, you already could have done it.
Yeah. It's 1d8 plus your spellcasting ability modifier. My ability modifier is 5. What the hell is 8? Oh, this one.
8, it's you know, eight. After 7, 4, 9.
I hate you, and I rolled an 8 plus the 5.
Okay, so he got...
That's a little bit better.
Yeah, 13 HP, all that's not too bad. Tip.
But I'll treat him the same way Sam treats Smeagol and you know.
So he's currently at 46 HP.
Well, he doesn't need to follow us if he doesn't want to. I was just like, he's a mercenary.
Okay. And he says,
so you basically just healed him for the amount of damage that Hensloy just inflicted on him.
Yeah.
More or less, yeah.
I don't have, like, super healing yet.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, we're only level 5, so, I mean, it's not too...
I mean, I could cast Goodberry, too, but I don't want to waste another spell slot.
You're damn right, Carl. And, okay, so you are sitting there, and you kind of hear a bunch of rattling and banging and whatnot from the third room sitting up there.
All right.
Guz is sitting there like, oh, I just don't want to take any more damage. That hurt. You caught me with your axe on my side. Oh. And then I was charged by a minotaur. Right. This is terrible.
I have a couple of seeds in my bag. I can use Alter Plant to make them grow and, like, put it on his wounds.
He doesn't have
it'll
any...
Take a,
he doesn't
it'll
have
take
any
a long
grievous
time
wounds
to heal.
Currently, so, I mean,
oh,
it's not
okay.
Like he's bleeding out or anything.
Okay,
the armor did still
then.
Take, the brunt of the blow.
I asked Guz, hey, do you have any, like, insight or info or anything before we go up there?
Look, you're gonna want to watch out. He has this,
He has this wand that can turn things into other things. I think that's what he did to the sheep. Is the sheep still here? Do you guys still have that sheep?
That's a
that's actually a good question. What happened to the sheep?
Yeah, we still have the sheep.
Where is the sheep?
That's a good question.
He's just waiting outside.
Hannah's supposed to be holding the sheep, but I don't know what he did with it when he attacked.
I put him down outside.
Okay.
Okay.
I just say the sheep's over there.
Look, that sheep was originally Master Noak's master. I don't know if he already told you or not. He's a sheep. It's kind of hard to talk. I can kind of pick it up, you know, sometimes with his bleating and whatnot. Yeah, so he pretty much turned him into a sheep. And I don't know, I guess Noak wanted to be the all-powerful one. And I don't think he is. I think he's gone a little mad, if you know what I mean.
Alright.
How was that an if you know what I mean statement?
What?
I say let's go up there.
How was that statement that deserves if you know what I mean?
I don't know.
What? I'm just going to go up there. Let's go.
I have a big question. Why does the orc got a Cockney accent?
Because that's how orcs speak, man.
Okay. Okay, so, well, anyways, Gumi looks down at Geb and kind of goes, hey, can you catch me? And it takes forever to climb back down.
Slither back into the bottle.
Yeah. So, Gumi...
Wait, shouldn't you stay out? I mean, we're about to fight the guy.
I mean, the door's way over there.
You hear even more louder rattling and banging.
Okay, and pick him up. I just pick him up and we go. Let's go.
Okay. Should we wait until Day gets back, I guess? Because it works with Cockney.
Sure.
Okay, well, anyways, Gumi's gonna slide her way down and then hoping Geb catches her.
Okay.
Geb does it and you fall.
Alright.
Well, I mean, you're a slime. You just kind of probably squish.
I know, but it still hurts.
Yeah, it's true.
Does it, though?
Yes, it does. I do have resistance against, like bludgeoning hits. But it's still damage. You know?
Weird.
I guess so, yeah. Alright. Is Day back?
So is Geb gonna catch me? Or am I just gonna hit the floor?
Oh, yeah, he's
gonna catch me. No, I caught you. We're going. Anything,
yeah. Okay.
Oh, it hurts gonna, its feelings.
She's gonna reload her pistol.
Okay.
Okay. We ready?
Okay, so, yeah, you guys hear a lot more banging and pounding and whatnot, and... As you guys are all starting to walk towards the door, out of the roof of the building bursts a dragon wormling.
Okay.
And Noak is currently riding on the wormling.
Are you kidding me?
Nope.
Roll for initiative?
Yes, because this is a new combat, so.
Yeah.
Who's rolling? Everyone?
Everyone. Okay.
Everyone is currently in party.
That's a useless nat 20, but a nat 20.
Oh, well, there you go. Take two yeah, turns. Yeah.
No. You're gonna think I'm bullshitting after fucking Geb, but I also rolled a 20.
So did I.
Bullshit.
What the fuck is going on?
Hey, Hen, did you roll a 20?
Damn it, I got a 10. Fuck all y'all, I got
You should have just said 20, I would have let it slide.
Well, I think I'm the first. I think I'm the first one, though. So doesn't that mean I go first, or
I guess so, unless you want to play a game of.
I mean, do you have an initiative modifier?
You want to play a game of Gwent?
I think we all have plus two.
We all have plus two.
Is it okay? Then you guys decide
who's faster,
whoever you want to
do. Speed. Who's got the faster speed?
We're all at 30.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're all at 30 in speed. Okay.
Just roll again. Just roll again.
Okay. Fine. I rolled a 17 plus 2 is 19.
Hmm. I rolled an 18 plus 2 is 20.
I rolled 18.
God damn it, Geb. Okay, I'll let Geb go first.
No, I rolled 18. Oh, but no, I mean like mine ended up being 18, so I'm 30.
Okay, so mine's 20 because it was 18 plus 2.
Oh, okay, that's no problem. Okay, out of the what's it called?
Oh, Hen's already rolled 20.
What was Hen's? Hen, yours was a 10, right?
10.
Okay, yeah, that's fine, whatever.
Is that with the modifier?
You have an initiative modifier.
I guess mine would be... Well, oh, where's my initiative?
Probably
thing?
A 2.
Oh, right. No, it's a 1, so 11.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Why do you only have a 1 for an initiative modifier?
I think it's because of his stats.
Okay.
Well, it has to be because of my stats. It's the only really thing that determines it.
Okay. Yep. And... All right. Anyways, so this this gigantic beast kind of bursts out of the roof of this building. It's a dragon that it looks like it's carved from wood with billowing bedsheets for wings and a tail that ends with a soft pillow.
Billowing bedsheets.
This is a
he transmuted his bed into a dragon.
This is a bed dragon wormling.
A bed dragon wormling.
Yes, sir. So,
alrighty.
There we go. And both of them rolled lower than you guys, so go for it.
Okay. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn to Day, Caden, and I'm gonna ask Caden to throw me up at the ceiling so I can latch on and get a new sniper position.
You're gonna need to do a strength check for that one then.
Okay, so this is okay.
Okay.
Strength check. D20.
Oh, God.
15 plus 4.
You got
3.
It.
So 18.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah. Okay, so.
And I don't have to make an ability check for climbing onto things.
No, no. So Day somehow grabs a big gelatinous blob of slime and throws it straight up onto the ceiling. And with a. You are sitting up there now.
All right, and so. And as my extra. Action, I will I'll use that other ability I used last round.
Okay, so you're gonna do sniper mark again?
Yeah.
On which there is both the dragon and Noke riding on the dragon.
I'm gonna target Noke.
Noke? Okay, gotcha.
Yeah. So I have the accuracy to hit Noke and not and just Noke without hitting the dragon.
Gotcha.
Okay, right. That's my turn. I can't attack in the same turn because I used my move action.
Right, right.
All right, so the Geb's turn.
Nope.
No, it's Day. Nope.
It's Day? Okay.
I'm
although if they're flying away, Day's just going to be standing there with his axes going.
No, they're not flying away. They're currently he crawled up out and he's currently flying up around you guys.
Okay,
it's
combat
still time with him.
He's still outside of my any kind of melee range, so
yeah,
I'm kind of
unfortunately
I'm kind of stuck. Like. Okay. I can throw... You know what? Ooh. Idea.
Ooh.
My bound axes, I can summon them back to myself at any time, so I can throw them and then just have it right back when I want.
Now, do you have a proficiency for throwing weapons, though?
No.
I would think that since they're your bound weapons, you'd still at least be able to use it, so you can throw it. It's just you don't have any advantage or anything.
Right. Let's see. Weapon proficiencies, martial, simple, and great axe. I don't have any kind of throw.
I mean, you could, but it'd probably just drop.
Yeah. Okay. No. I think I'm gonna have to pass.
Okay. Do you don't have any of your like invocation things to affect him or something?
No, I don't have anything like that right now.
Okay.
High enough level. I took the wrong. The wrong spec if I wanted to do any kind of casting.
Question.
Yes.
Oh, wait. I do have something I could do. I can start concentrating for the Aura of the Damned.
If you like.
There you go.
So, Aura of the Damned. At the end of my turn, any creature within 30 feet must make a constitution saving throw or take 1d4 times my character
level. That includes us.
Any creature? Oh, wow.
That includes us.
That would be like 20 damage.
And
this
is probably a 60 foot wide. Like,
okay, yeah, no, I'm not even gonna bother.
Please don't do that.
I am directly above you. I would for sure get hit.
Okay, yeah, so, fine. I won't.
Question.
Yeah.
Is the wand? Does he have the wand out?
You see that he does have a wand out.
Ooh, I could aim for that wand come my turn.
I am going to cast Minor Summoning. I'm going to summon a bird and try and have it try and fly to get the wand.
Okay, you're definitely going to have to do some type of check for that then.
Okay. Let's it's check, I guess.
Well, yeah, I mean check, contest, whatever. Fuck, what would we do for that one? For grabbing something?
Dexterity?
I would say dexterity.
Yeah, I guess so.
Or
yeah.
On his side, but I mean, like, what about the bird's side?
It wouldn't be me, it'd be him, the bird.
Either way, then just, I guess do a dex roll? Yeah. Because I'd have to do a savings roll for that, probably.
I got 19.
19? Shit. Yeah. I got nat 20. No. Okay.
I honestly, with a gnome riding a bed dragon, I don't think I'd be that surprised.
Yeah, that's true.
Say Geb's at a disadvantage here.
Grapple check plus dex modifier.
Would I be at disadvantage?
Sorry?
Should I be at disadvantage?
You are sending a bird to go fly up into a dragon. And
18.
Yeah. That's your disadvantage roll? You rolled a 20 and an 18? Jesus.
No,
okay.
No, 19 and an 18.
Oh, okay, okay, gotcha.
Oh, God, no. If that was a nat 20, I would have been so pissed.
Gotcha, okay. Okay, so I guess you fly on up and you take the bird takes the wand from Noak. And he's kind of batting away and swinging at it and whatnot. Okay. Does it bring it back? Are you gonna have it bring it back to you or what?
Yeah, I had it. It comes and brings it back to me.
Okay, gotcha. All right. Well, Noak is more or less powerless, so I guess the dragon is just going to do his thing. So he flies down because remember, you guys are both. He broke out of a building. You're in a building. So.
Well, before you do that, can I just like have? I'm just looking at the wand.
Yeah, that'd be an arcana check then, if you want to like actually check to see what it is.
I got a that went halfway. That is a 10.
A 10? Okay.
Yeah. Ten. Do I have
plus whatever your arcana is?
Wisdom, I think.
I have plus 5, so that's a 15.
15? Okay. So you can kind of see it's a bit of an ornate wand. It has a small what it looks like. It looks almost kind of like a tree. There's small branches curling up to the top of it, and then it ends up at a point. There's a small little flourish at the bottom. You can definitely tell it's magical. It's pulsing with magic of some type, but you can't exactly tell what it is.
Okay. I'm going to keep just like looking at it while the dragon takes its turn.
Okay. So the dragon bursts through the ceiling of the building you guys are currently standing in. And since you guys are all more or less... Oh, okay. So, he kind of lands.
I was about to say, Gumi's at the ceiling. Is he near Gumi?
It definitely is jarring. Make, athletics check, Gumi, to see if you launch off or not.
Oh. Okay, let's see. I got a 9.
9? Okay, it rumbles and shakes, and unfortunately, you fall back down.
That means I land directly onto Day.
Yeah, I was gonna say I'm right underneath her.
Okay,
so I take Day down with me.
I get all right. You guys both get knocked prone to her. The dragon lands, and I guess since he's in your guys' way, he uses his fun ability. Splinter breath. So, let's see. Actually, all four of you. No. Yeah, you're all in about the same area. All four of you make a dex check. Dex save, sorry.
Wait, do we get a disadvantage for Day and I because we're prone currently?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Okay. Wait. I'm getting burned. I got a 9.
Let's see. I rolled a net 20 and a 7.
That's a saving throw plus whatever you rolled, right?
Yes.
You rolled a 27?
Yeah. No. I rolled my two rolls were a net 20 and a 7.
Oh, yeah. I was like, Jesus.
Now remember,
you nimbly phased through the fire.
No, I said it was splinter breath. Remember, he's a wooden dragon.
Oh, that's right. I rolled 17.
You guys are going to need some tweezers.
So I'm at disadvantage, so I have to take the 7 plus my dexterity modifier of 2. I rolled a 9.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I have to roll twice. Let's see if I get a better roll.
Rolled a 17.
No, worst roll.
He's made of wood.
I know. I only did one roll, so I rolled again, and I still end up with a 9 because I only rolled one high.
Okay, gotcha. And then Hen is kind of like off because, you know, he tackled Guz and he's still sitting there. So he doesn't have to do that. But whoever rolled...
because I got a 1.
Whoever rolled under a 13 takes 24 piercing damage.
Now that's me.
If you pass the save, you take half that.
I take half that. Okay.
Yeah, so what?
Wait. What happens if you roll half?
If you rolled under a 13, you take 24 damage, piercing damage. If you rolled above a 13, you take 12 piercing damage.
Okay, so I took 24 damage then. I'm not too hot right now. I have 12 health left.
Okay.
I'm at 29.
Y'all are cacti now.
They are currently covered in splinters.
Yeah, both Day and I got fucking owned right there.
They are.
That was a bad circumstance. I get knocked off the ceiling. We both get knocked down. And then we get covered in splinters everywhere.
Oh my god.
You guys got wood.
Oh my god. Okay, yeah. And Noka, you stole his wand. He can't really do too much, unfortunately. So, it is whoever's turn is next.
Who's first again?
No, Halo.
Halo, Hen's Day, turn. And
then... Oh, yeah.
No. It's Hen's turn. Hen's turn.
Hen rolled got an 11 for his initiative. You got
Yeah, and I rolled a 19. Or 20. And I went first. My roll was getting onto the ceiling.
Yeah, Hen hasn't done anything yet.
Yeah, I haven't.
Oh. Oh, okay, so it's
What am I supposed to do? Try to pull out your splinters?
If you want to.
The dragon's on the ground. It landed.
Oh! Charge at that thing, then.
Are you going to charge again?
I'm going to charge.
All right, roll the...
What's wrong, Keb?
Roll your...
What do you do? I charge it.
Roll that AC check, Hen.
AC meaning tell you what my armor class is?
No, make a roll to see if you hit this thing, because charging very quickly...
Just a D20.
It is a relatively nimble dragon, so...
But just a D20?
Yeah, C1.
Okay, 16.
16? Okay, you plow directly into this fucking thing with both your horns. You just gore into this wooden dragon, which I don't know if that's going to break
horns
your horns or something.
Stuck.
Yeah, you are stuck inside a bed dragon currently.
Oh, did it break Hen's horn? That'd be hilarious.
No.
I rolled for damage too, right?
What are those? It was 2d6? 2d8?
Oh, yeah, right.
2d6, I think.
2d6.
Yeah.
2d8, it seems a bit high for horns.
Oh, boy. Double 5, so 10, and then plus my strength, so 17.
Damn, girl. All right. You took good... As you sit, you ran, and you gored it. This time, you didn't actually fall down. You kind of, like, gored it, caught it right on the side, and a nice big chunk of wood just blasted off of this dragon. And
now I got wood.
And Noak happened to fall off. And this wood just blasted over. And because Noak fell down, he lost concentration. The dragon, you see, it shimmies a second. And then it shrinks back down into an old dusty bed.
Oh my god.
So, yeah. Congratulations.
Now take a sleep on that bed.
Congratulations, okay. You killed a bed.
So, is combat over yet?
Combat is not currently... Well, yeah, I guess it is.
I mean, well, okay. Noak's still away. Still is he still there?
Noak, he sits there.
Noak is still there.
Is he still attacking us? Essentially.
Technically, yes. Hold on.
Then that means combat's still going.
Zero, stop fucking spamming.
Okay, anyway.
Okay, then Does he do his turn, or he did his turn. That's when he did the splinters and all that.
He has not yet. No, that was the dragon. Remember that?
Okay, so is he gonna do his turn?
Yeah. So he's sitting there, and he's kind of saying, "No, you won't take me. You won't." And he pulls this second, like, large brick of a wand out from underneath his robe, and he casts it, and there's a big kind of like a cracking, like a thunder striking noise, and all of a sudden, where Noak once was, is this pile of flesh and mouths and eyes, and the unfortunate.
Is it like a Resident Evil monster?
It is. It's technically called a gibbering mouther. It is essentially a big pile of. It's essentially a pile of flesh with a bunch of mouths on it, currently constantly screaming.
So I don't have the polymorph out of wand?
Hats, but in real life.
What?
So I don't have the polymorph wand?
No, you had his actual attacking wand.
Oh, cool. I have a wand now.
Yeah, because he was going to be casting spells at you otherwise.
Oh, okay. Sweet. I have his wand.
Awesome. All right, so the mouther is kind of just sitting there, and he's taken aback because, you know, obviously just transformed into this, so...
Does it have any limbs, or it's just mouth flesh?
It is just, like, it's kind of like a slime in a sense. It's just a big, like, mass of wriggling flesh with mouths all over it.
So, oh, I found a perfect picture.
Oh, God.
Whose turn is it?
Is it something like the first half of this?
Yes, actually. Let me take that picture so I can put that on the twitchy twitch.
That is horrifying.
Okay. So,
my God.
Guys, anyone like watching at girlfriend. Home, this is what a gibbering mouther is, more or less. It's fucking nasty looking.
I mean, to be fair, that also has eyes, but still.
Yeah, well, it's just a big mass of flesh and eyes. Yeah, it's kind of like Gertie, except much more terrifying.
So now, but Gertie has, like, a clear...
There's the gibbering mouther. Alright, so, you guys have... You have somehow successfully turned him into a horrifying mass of flesh, so...
Wait, we turned him into that? Oh my God. Like, even as much of an asshole as he is, feel good about
he
that.
He kind
of
turned himself into it because he used the wand and it backfired.
Should we do something? Should we just, like, put him out of his myth? I'm sure he's in pain.
Question.
Right? Yeah.
Are Day and I just out of commission for, like, this turn, or...
We have to spend an action to stand up again.
Yes. Yeah, because you guys are, one, covered in a...
We can't attack.
You're covered in a mess ton of splinters, and you were knocked prone. So, yeah, you have to spend your turn just getting up and repairing this turn.
Okay. Well, I guess Gumi will... Very, very, very painfully gets up. She is in a lot of pain. Yeah. She's more than half dead.
Jesus. All right. Okay, so this mouther is just kind of sitting there. You are just hearing it constantly babbling just words.
So it's my turn?
And anyone that attacks on him has to do a wisdom savings throw.
Does that count spells?
Anything.
Okay, I'm going to cast...
Yes, it's a flesh vagina.
What if it doesn't, attack him?
If you're in the radius of him, regardless if you're doing any action towards him.
But what if it's not towards him? Because I can cast Flaming Sphere, and it summons a sphere near him.
All right. At each creature that starts its turn within 20 feet of the mouther can hear the gibbering must succeed on a wisdom savings throw.
Am I within 20 feet of him?
No, the other two are, but you're good.
Okay, then I cast Flaming Sphere. It's got a 60-foot radius to, or a...
Jesus.
Like, cast range, I mean, and it's a 5-foot sphere, so I put it right up next to him.
So you just chuck this big flaming spear at him?
Yeah, it doesn't go at him, it's just right next to him.
Okay.
And then once he ends his turn, he takes 2d6 fire damage.
Okay, cool.
And I think that's all I can do.
All right.
I step back a little bit. Just step back a bit. Just to make sure I'm really out of that radius.
All right.
A little vacuum pill.
And you two that are getting up, you have to roll a wisdom savings throw.
That's you, Dan Halo.
Yeah.
Oh, I got up. I already spent my turn.
Okay.
Yeah, I was going to say, we spent our turn standing up.
Yeah, that's right.
It went Halo, and then me standing up, and then Geb, and now...
I didn't read too quickly, so we'll do that afterwards. We'll do that next time. All right, and then, so what do we got? We have Hen left, right?
Yep.
And you are, I mean, you are poised at the ready. You weren't knocked down this turn.
No. So, I have not been paying attention. What's going on?
There is a gigantic mass of gibbering flesh staring in between.
Oh, right.
There.
Get it out of its misery. Yeah. I'm going to just, like, slice that thing.
You want to attack it?
Slice and dice.
Make that AC. Check.
So let's see. What's my thing? For a battle axe, I think it's 3d6.
Well, we'll make your AC check to see if you hit it first. I have a bag of holding.
13.
13? Okay, yeah, you definitely hit it.
And then 3d6 for my axe. Oh my god, you're joking. Oh my god.
Now, before you attack, like I said, make that wisdom savings throw. Make a wisdom.
So roll a d20 and then apply your wisdom modifier.
Okay, hold on. Mm-hmm. So just 7 for wisdom.
Just 7?
Ouch.
Straight up?
You failed.
Okay, you cannot. All right, you cannot do anything on this next turn, and you have to roll a d8 real quick.
Wait, roll a d8 right now.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
I almost just covered my floor.
Okay.
Roll that d8.
I got a 7.
You got a 7? All right.
Yeah.
Doesn't look like it can't attack. Okay. Well, you just make a random melee attack against a creature. It happened to be, since the only thing around is the mouther, you still attack it.
So do I tell you what I...
Yeah, what's the... What was that 3d8 roll or whatever?
Yeah, because I got 1-1-1.
Really?
You're not
messing with us here?
My strength modifier is +7, but I got 1-1-1.
So you get 10.
So you did 3 damage?
10 damage.
No, okay, 10 damage. Okay, there you go. So you, as this thing is gibbering and screaming at you and everything else in its vicinity, it's kind of like piercing your mind, kind of like nails on a chalkboard, and you can hear that it's just yelling and screaming all these different words and things at you, and in a rage, you just kind of take your axe and bash it. You just cut off a big chunk of flesh, and it just kind of lands on the ground. A big chunk of mouthy flesh.
Does the chunk still move? Is it kind of like that? Or
it's kind of like wriggling around, and then it just kind of stops.
That's just horrifying.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not a pretty sight. Not at all.
All right, well, then I guess it's... if Hen just went, then it's going to be my turn again.
Mm. And, was and the chunk of flesh...
the monster is the turn.
What? Oh, yeah, sorry. Okay. Unfortunately, it can't exactly do... it doesn't do much since it's just a big pile of flesh.
Is that its turn? The end of its turn?
No, that was Hen's turn. He can...
Okay.
He actually can use 2 attacks if he wants. Let's see. We currently have the... No, the mouther. we currently have the 2 of you guys that just got up, right? And then Hen, which grabbed a chunk off of this fucking thing.
Yep.
Oh, God. You think that would taste good?
So we're at the bottom of our initiative list right now, then.
Gotcha. Okay. Let's see. You guys are not close enough for it to bite you, unfortunately. But it does, you kind of just hear like this, and it hawks this gigantic big like glob of just nastiness, like phlegmy flesh, right at both you, Day and Halo. Yeah. And you guys have to do a dex savings throw or you are blinded till the end of the next turn.
God, it looks like to not commit another turn.
You're trying to hit a 13.
I'm not at a disadvantage anymore, right? Because
no, you guys are up and doing everything.
All right.
Okay, I rolled. All right,
so I got a 24.
Oh, you're good.
I rolled a 15, and my dex modifier is, I think, 2, so I got a
17. Okay, yeah, so the flash, it kind of gets like, and you guys kind of shield your eyes, and it's fine. And, all right, now it's your turn again, the party turn.
Halo. Ended its, wait.
Oh, yep, that's right.
If it ended its turn, it takes 2d6.
Oh, that's right, okay. So, let's see, 10 and then 2d6, you said?
Yeah.
Where is my d6? I get D6. Then I get D6 again. Really, the one thing I can't find is a D6. There we go. 1. Okay, so it takes 3 damage. So in total, it's taken 13 damage so far.
Alright, so now that Gumi is recovered, despite being covered in wooden splinters, she picks up her gun, and she aims it for... I don't know. Does this thing have, like, a prominent eye? Is there, like, one eye that's bigger than the others?
Yeah, it kind of has, like, a big ring of eyes, and there's a big one in the center.
All right, she aims for the big eye, and she tries to shoot it. Still with the advantage against, I guess, with the advantage applied again.
Okay, gotcha.
Because it wore off. It had been a minute.
Right. All right, so make your attack, then. Do the AC roll real quick, and then make your attack.
All right, let's see. Okay, for accuracy, I rolled a 16.
All right, cool.
All right, and I guess for damage, let's see. Also a 14 like last time.
Okay, so you do a straight 14?
Straight 14.
Damn, okay. Oh, that's right. You didn't hit it the first time, right? Because you guys got knocked off and landed on Day, right?
Yeah, I mean, the last time I fired at something, which is a little bit.
Okay, gotcha. Alright. Yeah. Oh, fuck, you're supposed to do that goddamn wisdom save. Okay, whatever.
I can do a wisdom save if I need to still.
Go for it. You're trying to beat a 10.
Beat a 10, d20?
Yes.
Okay, I got 11 through the roll, so...
Okay. Be fine. All right. Whoever makes an action against him, once again, just do a wisdom the saving throw first.
Okay. So
because remember, this thing is still screaming at you with 100 mouths.
Right. I'm next. I rolled a 12 for that wisdom check.
What about my bullet shot? Did it do anything to its one eye?
Huh?
Did it do anything to its prominent eye?
Oh, that's right. You shoot it and you pierce it. This large, big orb. And you just, with a sickening, it kind of pierces through. And who was, one of you guys was really close to it, right? Hen, you pretty much just hacked it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you get somewhat showered in eye juice.
Yuck.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Nasty.
He has to do a wisdom saving throw so he doesn't go insane from just that.
Oh, that is just you're good. That's rancid.
Okay.
Right. So whoever is next.
That would be me. And let's see, I rolled a 12 for the wisdom thing. My wisdom modifier is -1, so I got an 11.
Either way, you're good. You're hitting a 10, so.
Okay. I'm going to flat out attack him.
All right, go for it.
And use both my attack moves, so I'm going to be hitting him 4 times, trying to.
Do your accuracy first to see if you hit it.
Let's see, I rolled a nat 20 and a 13.
Okay,
Hold on, hold on, that 13 is plus 6, so that's 19.
Okay, was that for your AC roll, or for both of them?
Hold on 1 second, I need to check something as well, because I might have something else.
Okay.
That is...
What did you just do, Vortex? You made something. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. Right. Okay. This hasn't affected anything yet, but I have as part of my Dark Order, I have a crit at 19 or 20.
I just want you guys to know that Vortex did make an overlay for us, and it is a lot better than the one I just made. So.
Are you going to link it into Skype?
It's on there. It's on there right now. I'm sure it'll take you a second. It'll take a second, but yeah. This is beautiful. Okay, anyways, so what'd you do?
So I rolled a nat 20 and a 13.
Okay, so for your two attacks?
For my two attacks.
Oh my god.
It's beautiful.
I love it.
Why is yours a squid choking a horse?
Because that's essentially what I am.
Oh Damon's my god, Dave.
What is mine? What is that?
You're Mr. Claw from Inspector Gadget and stroking a cow.
Hey. Which put my icon like in the tiny corner of the mine.
What?
Yeah, my icon.
Why
my
is it glitching?
Huh?
Why is it glitching?
Is anybody else seeing
it? It is glitching, yeah.
I don't see any glitching.
It is, yeah. I definitely see glitching.
I don't see any on Twitch right now.
I don't see any on the stream.
Draw something useful, like our characters at battle.
Halo, he is useful, man. All right, that's going away for the time being.
Okay, there, it's not glitching anymore. Okay, so I rolled a nat 20 crit and a 19.
For your two hits?
For my two hits.
So 20, or what, 39 damage?
No. Okay. Those are my AC rolls.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. For your two hits. Okay.
So.
All right. Let's see here. Do your damage hits.
My damage hits. So let's see here. 2.
I love it.
I got an 18 and a 20. So.
So 38 damage.
38 damage total. Yeah.
Well, okay. With your, Jesus Christ.
I basically take these two giant axes going boom. Okay. Boom, boom.
So you take your gigantic axes and this thing is just still gibbering and screaming at you. You just carve this motherfucker up like a turkey. You just hacking flesh and mouth and eyes off of this fucking thing. And it is just it is just like in this thing. It's in its own puddle of like flesh and okay.
And this whole time I'm just smiling and laughing.
I'm pretty sure whoever's turn is next will finish it off, but
that's mine, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Put your wisdom in then.
But I'm not near it.
Oh, that's right.
I think I will. No, wait, I'm about to finish it off, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it is.
Then I'm not gonna cast. Okay, I'm not gonna cast Conjure Animals then. That'd be a waste.
That's what amnesia says.
Enzoid, you froze again.
Can I strap a bomb? Can I summon a sheep and strap a bomb to it and run the sheep out?
No.
Wait, am I frozen?
Okay, I'm just going to take out my bow and just hit him.
Okay. It doesn't really matter what you roll. You're gonna kill him. He's pretty much
What's his AC, I guess?
His AC... Roll it. 2?
No, I got a nat 20.
Well, you guys are doing really good with this.
That wasn't a lie. Oh my god.
With an almost...
Our rolls have been really good this session.
With an almost pitiful little drawback of your bow, you just loosen arrow... And with just going straight into the heart of all this flesh, and it just kind of it wriggles, and then it crumples on the ground, and there is just a puddle of flesh, mouths, and eyes sitting there.
This is so descriptive.
I'm trying to. And the Master Noak is no more.
Whoa!
That's oh my god.
Can we level up?
This whole time, the sheep has been sitting there. And hold on, this whole time the sheep has been sitting there, and he finally says, "Uh oh, thank God, you beat it. That was horrifying. Thank you. Now please, if you'll just turn me back."
I go and pick up the polymorph wand.
Okay.
Since I'm pretty much our only spellcaster here.
Okay. Oh, actually,
I know some spells.
But I'm our spellcaster.
that's right. You also did this. You also did the initial inspection roll, right, Geb?
Yeah.
Okay. So
but he did the inspection roll on the other wand, the attack wand. Remember?
That's right. Never mind.
Can I go and pick up the polymorph wand?
Okay, go for it.
I am going to. Can I do a?
Do an arcana.
Okay. I got an 18.
Damn. Okay.
Oh wait. 18 plus.
Your arcana is 4, I think, right?
5. 18 plus 5.
Okay.
I am our spellcaster, and I'm fine with that.
Okay. And you take a look at this wand, and you realize that there is,
Wait, what?
That was scary. Okay, you can see that this is like it's kind of like a long twig almost, and it has a bunch of cracking on it, and there's this small little brick looking thing that's kind of hooked onto it, almost like it's wired onto this wand. There's a lot of cracking on this wand. It smells straight like burning flesh. It is not a very pretty wand. You can tell it is incredibly unreliable.
I think I will stash that. Oh god, I have to turn it back, don't I?
My brain starts wondering then if he tried to use the wand on somebody else and it backfired and turned himself into a sheep now.
But I wild shape. So...
No, he's trying to turn something into a human. What if it backfires and turns Geb into human?
Oh!
Or, just
I'm just a really hairy mountain man.
You're a bear. You're a bear.
Just you went from one bear to that bear.
All right, you know what? Screw it. I'm going to take that chance. I'm going to try and turn him back.
Okay.
Do I need to roll or anything?
Oh, yes, you do.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Just remember what Noak turned into.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
But what was Noak trying to turn other things into?
Just remember what happens when Noak failed turning something into something.
Is it... do I need to... Is it, like, a specific, like, thing that it's for?
You have... It. He sits... The sheep sits there and he just goes, Please, just... Please be careful. Well, I don't want you becoming one of those things, too.
I mean, is it like a specific, like, is this intelligence or is this arcana or...
No, this is arcana as well.
Okay, so plus... 15 plus 5, so that's 20.
Okay.
Not a nat 20.
But a 20 nonetheless.
Yeah, not a nat 20.
Okay. No, he failed amnesiac. No one wants to become a gibbering mouther.
Okay. I mean, unless you're a really sick individual and that's what you want, I mean.
I mean, that it is. Okay, so as you sit there and you point the wand right at the sheep, and with another loud crack you hear and a big blinding flash, where the sheep once stood is a relatively tall elf. Lanky. He has a nice black robe sitting on, a long head of silver hair. And he sits there.
Is that what he wants to be? I mean...
That's what his original form was.
Ah, that's good.
Yeah.
He's like, I want to be a sheep! Turn me back!
And he says, oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I can't believe you actually went through with that. For a second, I thought you were going to, you know, steal my tower or something.
No, I did it, but I'm keeping these wands. These are mine now.
That is fine. I can always make another one.
Do you have anything cool for me for saving your tower?
Well,
anything cool for us?
I can, with my incredible power, I can completely make transmutations on any item that you wish. I will not charge you anything, whereas I would normally charge a very, very hefty sum of fee.
What do you mean by transmutation?
That is actually something I have to look up, because I don't know what a 5e transmutation is.
Like, Like, if I have the polymorph wand, can I have him transmute it into something else?
Essentially, yeah. You could pretty much... A transmutation is more or less kind of like alchemy, but not exactly.
Ooh, that...
Like... Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
As,
I'm like...
As someone who builds their own weapons, that sounds very useful.
Can... Can I have him change the properties of the polymorph wand?
You could possibly, yes.
Can I make him transmute the polymorph wand into a transmute mutating wand so I can use transmutating spells with it?
He sits there for a second. He ponders. He says, I could possibly do this because Noak... Let me see the wand. Noak destroyed this wand initially. You can see all the things that he put on, how it's all cracked and whatnot. It'll take me time, but I could turn this into something a little bit more powerful.
If you need, I have a magic branch, like part of a magic branch that was gifted by my goddess Flanaves.
That's oddly specific.
I know, it's from my backstory. It's
just, oh, okay.
Just, yeah, would that help?
He kind of sits there for a second.
You can either have it as a wand, or if you combine it and turn it into a staff, whatever you want to do.
I think I could do something like that. All right, here, give it here. I'll see what I can do.
Okay.
All right. So he gets to fiddling around with that. He said it's going to be quite a while. It's probably going to take at least a day or two, but I can get something for you. That's for sure. And as he kind of goes off onto the big board that he has, or yeah, like his big experimentation area, he says, oh before you guys, I do have a small gift for you. And he takes these bags, and he just kind of he hands you guys these bags. They look oddly like this. He says, here, these are bags of holding. I don't know if you guys have them, but
yes. They
will definitely help in your travels. If you've never seen a bag of holding before, if you look in it, there's a pocket dimension inside the bag. So you can as long as you can fit it through this opening, you can fit any infinite amount of items in here.
Ooh.
I immediately put all my stuff into my bag.
If it can, remember, it has to fit
into
through
the bag.
It has to fit through the bag opening.
I'm putting ladders in there. I'm putting my bow. I'm putting my greatsword. I'm putting on.
Can I go inside the bag?
Can you fit through the opening?
Oh, no.
Yeah, I didn't think so. Plus, would you really want to be in a pocket dimension?
Yes.
Hayden, you need to take me to the furniture store later.
Day, your mic is off.
I was going to say, our little slime girl could probably fit in the bag.
Yeah, no. Hayden, you have to take me to the furniture store. I'm going to make myself a home in the pocket dimension.
And
should we just put IKEA into the
that's what I'm saying. Put IKEA in there. I'll make my own home.
He looks at you for a second. What was your name again? Yeah. He looks at you for a second, Gumi, and he's like, you know, I think I can actually work that out. I think I can make a pocket dimension house for you.
Sounds amazing.
Here, let me see your bag. Like I said, it'll take about a day and a half.
Okay.
But what's left, and he kind of looks around, there's holes in his roof, there's holes in the wall, everything's destroyed. He's like, well, I used to have some guest quarters, but I don't think there are really up anymore. Plus, you did just kind of kill my bed, so. why don't you head on back? And when you head on back to town, and when I'm ready for you, I will send one of my I will send my assistant. And out of the kind of just sitting there that you guys haven't noticed this all time, there's a small gnome sitting there. He says, yeah, that's no problem. I can go get you guys whenever. Just let me know if you guys are gonna be staying over in Braygrove. Let me know.
Okay, Gumi goes up to wait, did the guy ever said what his name is?
Yeah, shit, I don't remember it now. His name is Finethir Shinebright.
She goes up to Shinebright. She asks for a little forge attached to the miniature, like, pocket dimension home. so she can make her bullets.
That's gonna be hard to work. I'll see if I can do it. If nothing else, okay. I'll at least have a house for you.
All right. All right. And then she slithers off and climbs back into her jar.
All right. And he kind of uses his magic, and the rest of the room and everything is slowly repairing itself around you guys. He says, "All right, head back to Braygrove. I'll see about something for this. I'll see if we can't do something for you." And then the dwarf kind of gets like, "All right," or sorry, not the dwarf, the gnome. He says, "I'll be seeing you soon. Don't worry." Bye. And actually, guys, everyone who's watching, thanks for watching. I think we're going to stop it here. We did a good 3 hours.
Sweet.
So if you guys like the story that
well, really
we
two and a half, because we spent like 20 minutes talking about magic in a 10 minute break.
That's true, yeah. But either way. All right. But anyways, thanks for coming out and chilling and listening to us ranting about random shit.
Yeah.
Also, this stream was not sponsored by Yoohoo or by Ricola.
It is not. Please Halls. Sponsor us.
That was Halls, not Ricola.
Oh, it was Halls.
Yeah, but this will be up on YouTube.
It's not sponsored by either or.
Henzoid, what are you doing?
Henzoid's a nerd.
God. I'm doing nothing.
Yeah.
He's trying to outshow you, Woods.
Why don't
dancing.
Yeah, why don't we, instead of just recording it, why don't we just stream it Thursdays?
That sounds so that much sounds fun. I had a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun this time.
Because that way we don't have to deal with the bullshit of like stopping and restarting and doing all that stuff.
Are you going to just upload it to YouTube?
Yeah, might as well.
Yeah. All right.
I may just leave in the whole fucking. I may even leave in the intermission where you guys talk about fucking magic for like 20 minutes. Why not?
That should be its own separate video. I feel though.
Eh, no.
An entire video of just ranting about magic.
No. Leave it in.
Yeah. That way they get the full stream experience on YouTube.
I don't know how long it'll take to upload a 3-hour stream, but okay.
Usually it takes about an hour.
Okay.
Yeah, if that...
Seriously?
We may not have a lot of stuff in Florida, but I at least made sure I had good internet.
So, okay, so this is now our Thursday streams.
All right, guys, so we at least have something scheduled, guys. We have a D&D stream every Thursday night.
Congratulations, you finally have a streaming schedule.
Yeah, now I just have to work on the other 6 days.
Yeah.
Alright, but yeah. So thanks for chilling, guys, and we are done for tonight. So goodbye.
Alright. Bye everyone. Bye.